Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, welcome to the show. I am the Beer Dad himself, Justin Allen, and we are here at the beautiful Craft Lounge, Beaumont, California, just north of the 10 freeway. Get off the freeway, head north, right on the corner. Go say hi to Jimmy. Go say hi to all the crew. Tell them the Beer Dad sent you. And we are here to honor our good friend, Joshua Kunkle. This is a very special episode dedicated to the BrewedMan. Josh, brother, I miss you like you would not believe. It's taken me a while to get to this point to actually record a show, but I couldn't ask to have better friends here for this, and for a good reason, because we're going to be drinking some of your recipes that were brewed by some amazing breweries here in the Valley. But we are joined by some good friends, and I'm going to introduce them. So our good friend Brando from the Craft Lounge, Brandon, right here next to me.
Hello.
Hello.
How's everybody doing?
All right. And we have Jimmy, the proprietor of the Craft Lounge. There he is. He's like a celebrity. Look at him.
What's cracking?
All right. And we're also got Ingrid sitting over there. Hi. Say hi, Ingrid.
Hello, everyone.
There's some guy just like lurking in the back over here. He looks like he's pumped. He looks ready. Soto, what's up, brother?
Buenos noches.
There he is. And also we have somebody that is near and dear to the Beer Dad and Brew podcast heart, because he is Mr. Alex, and he's a good friend of ours, Mr. Costa Weste Brewing. He's brewed beers with us. He's broke bread with us. We consider him family. Alex, I'm just glad you popped in. That's awesome. What's up, brother?
Glad to be here. Good to be here, and man, appreciate it. I'm excited to try some of these beers, you know?
He's got a dope-ass hat on, too.
There it is.
Love your hat, bro.
Debatable.
Right, Jimmy knows.
Debatable.
Love, bro.
I'll get you a nice brown and yellow hat. It'll look so much better on you.
Like a big turd on your head.
A little dookie brown, huh?
Big turd. We'll have peanuts on it, too. These still look good.
All right. So we are also joined by an awesome person. We have Ryan Blondell here from Brewcaipa here in Southern California, who we've actually got his beer poured. Ryan, he wanted a challenge, and so he picked through some recipes, and he decided to go big or go home, and that's what we're starting with tonight. So tonight we are drinking Josh's recipe, Joe's Revenge. It's a triple IPA, and the man that brewed it here off of Josh's recipe. Ryan, what's up, brother?
How you doing, Matt?
Oh, man, thanks for coming here. Thanks for everything that you did to help us out, you know, with Kunkle Fest and, you know, wanting to honor Josh. I know Josh was close to you. You guys had a lot of connections out in the Coachella Valley, and I just appreciate everything that you've done to help out.
Yeah,
so
many, many late nights spent at the tap room in La Quinta, so it was my pleasure, my honor.
All right, man, thank you. So you brewed a triple IPA called Joe's Revenge. How was the brewing process for you?
Difficult. It was a fun beer to put through the ringers of my system. It was almost too much. A lot of grain went in there. It was a fun little stuck mash that we had. It was way too much grain. I actually had to close the top manway port on the mash tun to get enough water to hydrate the grain. It was actually above the manway door, which is a first for me. So that was pretty fun.
Awesome.
But it came out pretty good, so I'm happy with it.
What size system do you guys run?
A 10 barrel.
That in La Quinta?
No, at Brewcaipa.
Oh, Brewcaipa. I thought you said you were in La Quinta. Sorry.
No, so for one point in my life, when Josh was living up in the Cove, La Quinta Cove, I lived up in La Quinta Cove, and there's a tap room in La Quinta that we would have to work, spend some time at.
Oh.
And so it wouldn't be uncommon to see Josh roll through, and he's like, oh, hey, wait here. And he would go home and go grab beer out of his fridge, and then we would just sit on the patio and drink homebrew.
That's awesome.
Even we had all these other beers to choose from. It's like, no, let's go drink Josh's beer on the patio.
Oh, yeah, man.
Way more fun.
Awesome.
A 10-barrel system.
Yeah.
And you cranked it.
Yeah. We maxed
almost to
it,
the limit.
Maxed it out. It was an angry, angry beer. I have video on my phone of the beer being brewed, and it was just... normally when you get a lot of protein in the beer, it'll get active in the boil, and it was trying to come get me. It was shooting out of the kettle, foam.
That's
all
Joe's
that.
Revenge.
Oh, I was
Joe's Revenge.
Like most of the time when you have a beer, you get to leave the brew deck and go do work on the fermenter and do some other stuff in correlation with that. But this one, I was on the brew deck the entire hour and a half of the boil.
Just
spraying it down the whole time, dude.
Well, everybody, why don't we take a sample here of this beautiful triple IPA? Oh, it looks like Jimmy's already jumped the shark over here.
He was thirsty. Joe, dude. It was Joe.
You talked him into it. So
wait till you see the revenge.
Yeah. So also, not to mention, Josh, I know you're here with us, and we have a pint poured of you of some wee heavy. Brother, this beer's for you, so cheers, everybody. Joe's Revenge from Brewcaipa.
Cheers.
Ryan,
cheers.
The brewer, thank
enjoy,
you, brother.
Guys. Thank you. Enjoy.
Cheers to Josh.
Mm, that's tasty.
That's good.
That is good.
He did a good job on that one.
Thank really you. Good. So it was a lot. It was a lot of work. And
yeah. That was. I'm trying to do quick math here in my head. And after that beer, it's kind of fun to do. It's like 1,000 pounds of grain went into this.
Wow. Ooh,
Jesus.
1,000 pounds of grain.
Yeah.
For Joe's Revenge.
2-row, 6-row. Got some Munich in there. Some Cara.
Okay.
Tons of Amarillo.
Yeah.
I had to order another case of Amarillo just for this beer.
Yeah.
There's so much Amarillo in it.
It's really good. Definitely, I know if Josh was able to taste it, I know he's here. He's watching us. I know he is. I feel him all the time. I'm sure you guys probably do too. He would be really happy with this.
Thank you, man.
He loved making those beers, you know, because they were in homage to his dad.
Yeah.
So he started with the Joe's IPA, and then he came up with Joe's Revenge. And every time he ever made them, people just loved them. I did. It was one of my favorites. And as far as, like, that West Coast style IPAs, I've always been, like, very picky about it. And so for a home brewer to make an IPA that I actually enjoyed, that was pretty solid. But we all knew Josh was an amazing brewer, and he come up with some pretty cool stuff, which hopefully we have some more of it continue here tonight with this. But solid job, Ryan.
Thank you.
I'm sure the people out in Ucaipa will enjoy it at Brewcaipa. I always get those crossed because it's like the same name. But
yeah, it's a fun one to tongue tie it.
Currently, for people that are going to listen to the show, it's on tap right now, right?
Correct.
Yeah, so head on out to Brewcaipa and help support Joshua Kunkle and drink a beer in his memory.
That's right.
Where is Brewcaipa? I know we're in Ucaipa, but how do people find the place?
It's just right on Ucaipa Boulevard. In the north part of town, so it's up by the White Pack, so it's right on the main boulevard. Okay. Where all the roundabouts are. So if you hit the roundabouts, you know you're close.
Not hard to find.
No, it's a few minutes from the freeway, north of the freeway, but it's really nice because we're super close to the mountains.
Yeah.
And there's usually a breeze, so we can open up the doors and it's nice and cool, even though it was really hot in the day, but in the evenings it cools off.
Nice.
Cool little vibe, cool clientele that we got there. A lot of locals that are really down to earth, really cool people.
Nice. All right, we'll go check out Joe's Revenge at Brewcaipa. So we'll drink this up here. Alex, what do you think of it?
It's good. I like it. It's a triple. Yeah, that's for sure. It's a big beer. No, and that's like the best way I can really say it. It's a big beer, and it's mighty tasty. And just to think that, you know. I wish I could have done something like this with Josh, man. Like some big beer like this. I mean, we've done the stout in the past, and something like this. I that's what I really wanted to dive into, and I think you did a great job, man.
Thanks, man.
It was really awesome. It was awesome.
Awesome.
Yeah, this is delicious, and I love the color too.
Yeah, I like the crystal came out and gave it a nice little amber hue to it.
Yeah. Was that crystal 40?
45, I believe.
Nice.
I'm sorry. No, it's just the Cara Amber.
Oh, cool. What was your final gravity on this?
So it started at 18.5 Plato. I don't know if you use SG or Plato.
I use SG.
Okay.
But I kind of understand the ballpark of Plato.
And it finished out at under 2 degrees Plato.
Oh, nice.
Dry as hell.
Wow.
I needed it to get that dry because I couldn't squeeze any more out of the starting gravities.
Right.
So to get it into that triple IPA realm, I needed
but
it.
But you know what? It still has that kind of like nice residual attenuate kind of like sweetness to it.
Yeah, yeah.
To balance out, to not be so hop and alpha heavy.
I think you're getting a lot of, because of the dry hop and whirlpool hops, I think you're getting a lot of hop sweetness in there too.
Yeah. And Amarillo isn't like a massive alpha heavy hop, so
no, but it's got this really cool orange juice aroma to the beer. I had to take some liberties with some of the hops that Josh used originally because in a production setting, sometimes you just can't go order a huge batch of something that you're going to use like 6 ounces of or a pound of in a beer. So I used some I use some like Willamette and a couple other things in there. And it,
dude, Willamette hops are awesome. I just use them in a beer, and I've been using them for a couple of years now.
Yeah, so there's a little Simcoe in there at the 10-minute mark.
Yeah.
You can't make a triple IPA without Simcoe. I don't think I've ever had a triple IPA that doesn't have Simcoe in it. Simcoe, Amarillo, Chinook. Oh, all the dank, nasty ass, like.
Oh, you gotta get the sea hops. Gotta have them sea hops.
Tree bark, fucking.
Little cascade.
Hops, dude, like, seriously, like.
You wanna right.
Mess around, throw some Fuggle in there, who knows?
Yeah, Fuggle around a little bit, yeah. Fug it, you know?
So, Soda, what do you think of this triple IPA?
Real clean tasting. It's definitely one of the more clean West Coast triples that I've tasted.
Yeah,
real. I don't know how to, but it just gives you that nice.
Yeah, it's got. I like how it's got a little punch to it, and then it kind of clears off your palate. So it's not hanging around.
Not overpowering.
I like the fact there's not a lot of hop burn. Right. So yeah. I get that a lot from triples on the West Coast side.
I backed off on a lot of the dry hopping on the schedule because the Whirlpool hops were so efficient. There was just so much isomerization from there that when I was tasting, I was like, we don't need to like.
Like, honestly, it would be perfect if you're sitting right by a pool. You'd just get crushed on this thing.
Ooh, you stay the fuck away from pools when you're drinking this, all right?
Yeah.
Hey, in my line of work, I don't want to have to deal with that, right? Listen.
I'm just picturing Soto after a crowler of that.
Yeah. I'd be like, be prime time, you know?
They bring him in, like, you know what I mean? The whole nine yards, and I'd be like, what happened?
He has a
Joe's revenge.
Joe's revenge.
Like, Joe, dang it.
I'm telling you, belly flop competitions are starting.
They're right after this.
Hey, you better put some big old floaties on, all right? I'm not going to deal with that.
I already got those. They're called guns, baby.
Hell no. No, man.
Those are those 24-inch pythons over there you got to watch out for.
Those are stones.
Coming in at those stones.
All right.
All right, Jimmy. You downed it first, so...
I kind of cheated. Sorry.
He was thirsty.
Me and Joe go back.
Okay.
It's great, dude.
Thanks, man.
I like it. I actually kind of like... There's a little bit of a malt background that I'm picking up on it that I kind of enjoy.
I like to have my IPAs with a little bit of malt, personally.
It's a little more on that American style.
I catch Munich
more. I like that.
Yeah, so.
Yeah, I like the type 1. Type 2 gets a little aggressive, but...
Yeah.
That's also what they say about diabetes.
yeah. Can't drink a triple IPA without a diabetes joke.
Diabetes.
Wilford Brimley.
Diabetes.
Diabetes.
Can I make a beer called diabetes?
Diabetes.
Oh, you could. You got the diabetes. I don't know if it would,
like I'm
going. You'll have a type 1 and a type 2. You know, we'll just see which one fits the best.
I'm pretty sure there is already a diabetes beer out there. It's called 450 North.
It's all 450.
Yeah. No, it's 450 North.
There's quite a few we can name.
Is that one of them smoogey beers?
Smooges. No, they don't make this. What's the? No, just 450 North. What do they call
them? They got those slushy
beers. Slushy beers.
Oh, the slushy ones.
Dude, honestly, I think those taste really good.
What?
The slushy, the 450 North. I like them. I think they taste good.
Those ones to me are a little oversweeted.
I don't know. I think they taste like what they say they are, though.
Sweeted.
So at least you get all the fruit and all the different.
You know what I really did like? One of those smoothie beers. I had it here the other day. You can pick it up at the Craft Lounge. Creative Creature did a collab with Mason L Works. And the can art's really dope because it's freaking garbage pail kids.
Mason McCreature?
Mason McCreature.
Yeah, Mason. Yeah.
Come pick that up at the Craft Lounge. That was really good. Good stuff. Not overly sweet, super thick, almost had a very like smoothie-like quality to it. And then, it's a big beer, too. I think it's got a little higher ABV, if I'm not mistaken. So check it out.
Something like 7-ish, I think.
Yeah.
7, maybe 8.
Only a five? Felt a little heavier than that.
Oh,
purple,
you know what
though.
I keep thinking?
Purple.
I keep thinking the
high flavor.
The Schmelzer. The Schmelzer from
Sandbox.
It's the
that one's higher,
imprint and Sandbox. That one's 7%.
Jesus.
Pretty awesome.
That will get you.
If you like zingers, buy that beer. It tastes like a zinger with a little pineapple.
Didn't you make homemade zingers one time?
One of my friends did for my birthday.
Yeah.
Remember we were drinking Space Jam.
That's right.
And we were eating homemade zingers, everybody got turned.
Space Jam night with Battle Logic here at the Craft Lounge. And that was a lot.
It was a lot of good times. We had a lot of other beers.
Diabetes.
You know, diabetes. You know, you're just trying to casually watch the prices right, and then you get
burned
on diabetes.
Yeah, yes, I did.
Do you still have both of your feet?
Do I?
Yeah.
Yeah, hell yeah.
They're still there.
Well, he has access to insulin.
At last count.
Oh, okay.
One of them, yeah, a lot of it. Right? I'm just kidding. They just give it to us.
Drip. He's got an insulin drip in his house, too.
Welcome to work. Here's some insulin and some Narcan. Why would I want Narcan?
Cool. Right on.
And a little, Dilaudid.
There you go. All right, so let's get into the second beer. We're going to go ahead and go into this because Ryan's going to help us out with this one because we don't have anybody available from Coachella Valley Brewing, but I want to thank Pete and it's Eric, right?
The yeah.
brewer. Pete and Eric for stepping up and taking this on and actually has some funny backstory to this particular beer. Jimmy knows what I'm talking about. But
I don't think I know this backstory.
So what's really cool is the night that we all met up shortly after Josh passed, all the brewers wanted to they wanted to talk to me and get some recipes so that they could make these beers. And so we met and everyone started picking some recipes. And I'm scrolling through them on my phone, and Pete from Coachella Valley Brewing, he goes, "What's that one?" And I scrolled past it real fast. I'm, "No, you don't want that one." And he's like, "No, no, no, what is it?" And I'm like, "No, no, no, really, you don't want that one." He's like, "No, what is it?" And I was like, "Well, that's something that Josh and I did together." And he's like, "Well, but what is it?" And I was like, "You're really not going to want to make it, okay? It's a hazy IPA with ginger and turmeric." And I thought right when I said that, he'd be like, "Okay, yeah, never mind." And then he just had this look on his face. Apparently, they had been talking about making a beer with turmeric already, and he was like, "We want to do that." And I was like, "Huh? All right, whatever." Because when Josh and I did it, the idea came to me because my mother-in-law is one of those, like, holistic, like, not to say a health nut, but she eats clean, drinks clean, and she's all about, like, turmeric and ginger for all kinds of different ailments. And they do work for a lot of ailments. But my wife is always constantly giving me these giant horse pills that are turmeric pills, and it's so hard to swallow them damn things. And so I get irritated, and so I'm like, "Josh, let's make a beer that has turmeric and ginger so I can tell my mother-in-law and my wife to back off because I'm getting my health food right here in this beer." And of course, you know, Josh, when you say something crazy about beer, he's like, "Fuck yeah, let's do it." Right? And so we did. And so he came up and we're like, we played with some recipes and I got a hold of some organic turmeric powder and ginger powder. And we went to work. Him and I brewed this beer. What we did do, though, is Josh overcalculated the turmeric and the ginger to where we put 5 pounds of turmeric and 1.5 pounds of ginger in a 5-gallon batch. Way, 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 way too much. So,
hey, but you got your intake of ginger.
No, we literally,
we'll never forget
I'm still
it.
Burning it off, dude. Burning off that batch.
We had enough turmeric as far as your daily intake to, like, help with inflammation and blood pressure and all that. Josh did the calculations. We probably had enough for 6 months in one beer.
That sounds nice. Yeah.
Yeah. I need me one of those.
So,
did it stain your teeth when you drank it?
No, it didn't. But it was very, so, you know, obviously the turmeric brings on that really harsh peppery flavor, and then the ginger just makes it spicy. And what happened was initially it was turmeric forward. After you let it sit for a while, then the ginger took over, and holy crap, did it get hot. And I still enjoyed it just because it was unique as hell, and it was something him and I did together, so it meant something to me. And when Pete said that he wanted to make it, of course, you know, even though I didn't want him to make it, at the same time I wanted him to make it. So I'm like, that's pretty fucking cool. So thank you, Pete and Eric at Coachella Valley Brewing, for making this beer. I'm excited to give it a try and see what it tastes like made at a professional brewery. I'm worried for Jimmy, though, because I'll never forget when Jimmy had it for the first time. He told Josh, don't ever make this beer again.
Word for word is what I said, Josh. I love beers, but please, don't. For the love of God, for the love of God, do not make this beer again, dude.
they definitely did not go heavy-handed on the ginger
good.
And turmeric. So
good. Well, we're gonna try it. So Brandon, he's gonna crack that.
No. That's it's in a crowler.
It's a crowler, and it's actually got a label with Coachella Valley on it.
There it is.
Bye. So. The name of the beer Josh and I made was initially called Mother-in-Law. It was Mother-in-Law's Hazy Home Remedies.
Okay.
So it was a double hazy IPA, and we called that just because my mother-in-law would give you home remedies to feel better. Oh,
there it
yeah.
is.
Ooh, he splooged on me. Thank you, Brandon. So
not a first time though.
I love what Coachella Valley did to pay homage to Joshua, and this is a. Kunkles Remedies.
Yeah, Kunkles Remedies.
So,
all right.
A little spillage.
So a little bit about this one. One of the things with CVB, because they were in production, like they're in production mode right now, a lot of busy time with pool parties and stuff like that, COVID reopening, bars, restaurants reopening. So their schedule was really tight. So they used the base of this beer off of one of their existing hazy beers. And the idea was then to add the ginger and the turmeric to give it the homage to Josh. And then they added some coconut on the back end of that, too. And one of the fun things that they did with this is with their hazy recipe, they ran high gravity on the first batch. They run four batches to fill up their fermenter. So on the first run, they ran it high gravity. So you basically have a double IPA.
Okay.
And so it's fermented. It's a 9%. And then Perfect. They were able to run lower gravity on the next runs to basically keep their... gravity on their regular house hazy, and then nice. They put it into a two-barrel fermenter. So they have two barrels of this beer sitting around. So
yeah,
something you can go pick up in the tap room right now. It's on tap right now.
Yeah, it's about the ABV is about where Josh and I got it. I want to say ours was like 9.4, 9.5.
Somewhere it's a big beer.
Yeah,
we're going big beers tonight, guys.
Big, we're going big or going home. So
gonna have a fun day at work tomorrow.
Yeah,
work.
So this is cool, Joshua, buddy. I know you're here. This was our beer that we came up together and thought it was god awful and great all in the same time.
Smell is crazy on this thing.
Well, yeah, the turmeric and ginger. I'm telling you, man.
Oh, man.
And a little sweetness from that coconut.
Did I miss the turmeric? Did I miss it?
No, you're right here.
Hey. That's not half bad.
No? Let's get into this thing.
I definitely get more coconut.
You get the coconut?
From tasting it than from the aroma.
Yeah.
Well, I was talking to Eric, and he said he put a lot of Sabro in it, and he tried to round this off with some Sabro, right?
Their Sabro's normally in their hazy.
Mm-hmm. Oh.
So. But they did dry hop this with the... They went a little heavier on some stuff to try to...
Yeah, try to...
Balance out the turmeric.
Well, because you're also dealing with the 9% as opposed to... I think your house was like 7, 6.5, yeah. Something like that.
Is this like a cleanse?
This
is.
Tell
you
your
guys intense. Did I miss the cheers on this one?
No, we did not.
As we are in a tent, this is intense.
Cheers to Home Remedies.
This is intense.
Coachella Valley Brewing. Thank you.
Thank you.
I do appreciate that everybody in the desert was so open to doing something for Josh.
Dude, right.
And then, like, even with CVB, they were like, I don't know. And then we just came up with that idea to just kind of use one of their others and do something fun, and just to see Josh's name up on the board at CVB is pretty cool.
Dude, I think it's so rad. And I remember a few weeks back, I was over at Desert Beer, and I got to try the Kunkle Dunkel.
Oh, that's up next.
I can't wait. I absolutely love that beer. And then it's just really rad to see everybody come together and brew his recipes. And
yeah.
I just love it. I think it's awesome.
I think it's something that for me, it's to go and sit and have so many beers from other places with Josh, and then to actually sit here and have his beers at all these other different places super awesome.
Right.
That was a good way to pay homage to somebody, man. I didn't really know Josh too well. I don't think I ever met him, to be honest, but just seeing the outpour from the community about this guy, he must have been an amazing person, you know?
Yeah.
I seen on BeerDad's here, or, sorry, yeah. But I seen it on his Instagram, and immediately I work at the golf course, and I was like, I want to donate to this because he seems like, you know, he was somebody that, you know, was well-loved, and I felt like it was something I wanted to be a part of, and I was just like, and I feel honored to be up on the stage. It was just something that, like, just came out of nowhere, and I just appreciate it.
Yeah.
Yeah, with Josh, one of the craziest things about Josh, I can go find you anybody, and I can go find somebody else that can tell you, hey, that guy's a jerk. That guy's an a-hole.
Yeah.
I cannot find anybody to say anything bad about Josh.
I dare you
to... No, but I mean, on a serious level, he truly was one of the nicest dudes out there.
Dude. I can imagine. I mean, I could see it just through, like, just this group of friends here that, you know, he was well-loved by a lot of people.
I always say, dude, he's amongst the best of us.
And he brings out good in everybody. I mean, you always... When you're around him, it's like... Just his personality and how he is with everybody, you want to be just like that. And You know, I miss that dude so much.
Yeah. Super humble, super sweet, honest,
yes.
but caring, though. He cared about people's feelings. And I miss him all the time, man. I just remember, you know, seeing him back behind the bar and, like, sharing beers, and we talked beer. And, like, you know, there's nobody else that could talk homebrewing with me the way he did, you know. And I was fortunate enough to go on a trip with, you know, Josh and Justin and, you know, hang out and have a blast in Houston. I got really close with him. And
you also got to see him get mad for about 0.5 seconds.
I did. I got to see him. Yeah, he was not very happy with us for getting lost in Houston, but it's okay. It was literally like, he was upset, and then it was just like, chill. He's like, yeah. He let you know. And there it was.
I can reenact it right now.
You can.
You stupid motherfuckers, how dare you, blah, blah, blah.
You missed out when he said,
dude, is that a
fuck
beer?
You, yeah. And
yeah.
Fuck you.
Yeah, and then you get a little pause, and then, oh, you know what? I'm sorry. I was just worried.
And he's like, I was like, yo, man, I get it. No worries, baby. I gave him a little huggy, and then we were all ready to go. And then we got a little more tour back, and then we woke up in the morning, and then me and him ate some Zofran, and we chucked tall boys out in the parking lot. Bye-bye.
I think that was the night where they got us on tape doing the synchronous snoring, too.
Nice.
All of us,
You had Josh on the floor. Like, he made him, I don't know why he did this, but he made himself this, like, bed, like, curled up in the corner, and he started it off with his loud, like, whistle snore. And then it would switch over to Brandon, and then it would switch over to me, and then back to Josh, and then
it's
so
like
my
a
uncle was
Stooges,
yeah, dude, it really was.
Different tones too. It was like
all three of us sound different when we start. It was so funny.
Oh, God, the person
who
next door
was Craig.
Oh, right, Craig filmed it. Yeah, because I remember it was like close-ups of our face too. He walked around. And he was like, "Oh, filming us, like pushing the camera up in our faces." I was like, "Damn." Like, that's what we sound like.
He was really into it. We'll just say that. So,
what I feel like he was like naked while he was doing that, though, dude.
He
was like,
he might have been.
He totally was. Yeah. I heard this.
It puts lotion on the skin.
I mean,
that's right.
It is pretty hot in Texas, so.
Yeah, right.
A little sticky. He goes, "I'm just a little sticky. Don't worry about it, bro."
it can roll out the quarters if you.
Yeah,
know
no,
what I mean.
That's just sweat that dripped on you, bro. Don't worry about it.
Ooh, wee.
Oh God.
Awesome.
It's what just a little bit of sweat, bro. It's a little bit of sweat. Don't worry about it.
Yeah. Oh man. So,
what
Jimmy.
Happened? Yes, sir.
What do you think of this Kunkles Remedies?
I think this beer should be made again.
It's good, huh?
This beer is fucking fantastic. I like it a lot, dude. I like it a lot.
Awesome.
I like what they did with it. There's some interesting-ass notes that I'm getting off of it from the ginger. I think it's the ginger that I'm picking up.
You know when they need to make this is next year, like when they actually have Coachella Fest? Because all them elf nuts that go to Coachella, they'll pound that stuff.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, yeah.
For
you
sure.
You mean it's healthy?
It's so
let me get that.
Yeah.
I would like to see him do it just to fun. Yeah. I would like to see it without the coconut. Just
to see, yeah.
Just to see.
See what it's like.
Yeah.
Look at Jimmy's like,
that would be, yeah, it would take a lot of the
there's no fun there. But, there's no fun.
Kind of reminds
no
me
fun.
Of
there's
like,
no fun there.
That's
no
being
fun.
Being a hibachi is just like extra ginger.
Right?
Extra ginger, extra fried rice.
And the FCC shut us down.
Yeah, dude.
It only,
just like, oh,
hey,
cancel culture, dang it.
In fairness, we made it to 28 minutes. Usually that's around like 8 minutes when we start screwing up, right?
Hey, that's all right. Hey, 28 minutes, I think we've gotten some pretty good content.
Yeah, we haven't
so far so good.
Or anything else? Yeah. Butt cheek sandwiches?
And we're only on beer number 2.
Oh, you missed that episode. You missed that episode.
This is going to get fun.
Yeah, right?
Oh, my.
You don't even know.
What time are we open till tonight?
Hey, Josh had an affinity for butt cheek sandwiches.
Yeah, he did. Yeah, we got to tell that story.
Oh,
so, yeah, correct me if I'm wrong, but, yeah, it's from a previous show. And, yeah, we were pretty tore back. Yeah. And I remember we were talking about, like, someone brought up the question if you were stranded in the snowy mountains, you know, after a plane crash. Would you
eat
your friend. Buddies? And Josh said he would start with the butt.
Start with the ass.
I'm like, dude, what?
Media spark.
And so he's all making like butt filet sandwiches and shit, dude, at some point. So,
so the whole night, Jimmy was giving him a bunch of, he was giving the rear end. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Good times. And folks, if you ever want to hear that, all you have to do is listen to some of our prior episodes. You'll find it. I'm not sure what episode that was, but it was
It's
it was before Houston, so.
You mean it was the Russian River one.
Oh, yeah.
There you go.
Yeah.
You should just name it the Butt Cheek episode.
Butt Cheek episode. I'll rename it. I'm going to go on Buzzsprout and give it a rename.
Take off the Russian River and just put
name it the Butt Cheek Bonanza.
Forget you, Vinny. We're calling it Butt Cheeks instead.
Butt Cheek Sub. Butt Cheek Torpedo.
Butt Cheek Sandwich. All right, let's break into another one.
Okay.
So, well...
Should we do Devon's? Do you want to do Devon's, the Kunkle, or do you want to go Citracopia?
Let's do that. Text Juan and tell him we're going to call him right now.
All
right. He's expecting our phone call.
Crack that whip
after
on
that,
me,
would you mind if I did an intervention?
Wait, what? Why are we doing interventions already?
Intermission. That's what I meant to say.
You said intervention?
I was like, man, wait. Do we got a problem?
I'm going to call everybody out and say, hey... Y'all got a problem. Y'all don't have a beer in your hand, a shotgun.
We know we have problems. That's why we're here.
We all have problems.
So you know what? I take it back. Yeah, intermission. Intervention. It's both.
Intermission and intervention.
It's like, let's all go drink some shotgun. Let's all go drink some shotguns.
Brandon always wants the shotgun. Look at him. He's excited.
You mind if I...
No, why? What?
You mind if I do that right now with these folks here?
Grab a
yeah, they look like they want to go home, huh?
Yeah.
Who does?
You guys mind?
Go do it.
I gotta bring him up here.
We can get him.
We get Juan on the phone while you're doing a shotgun.
Okay.
Shotgun him.
Did you tell him we're calling?
I said, are you ready for a phone call?
Yeah, let me know when he responds. I've got him right here.
Dude, I really enjoy this beer. I like this super relax.
Yeah?
I like it.
Yeah, it's definitely a polarizing beer.
It is.
It's one of those ones where it's like, hey, if you don't like ginger and turmeric, like, it's definitely predominant.
So our good friend Brandon here is always down to do some crazy stuff, and I feel like that should be live on Instagram. So
do it. Go. Yeah. Go Instagram.
It's been a while. Last time I did.
Party foul.
Hold on.
So don't start until I have a little toast.
Okay.
It's been a while. You got it.
Jim.
To quench your thirst.
Yeah. Are these for us?
Yeah.
Don't we shotgun a liquid death?
Yeah.
I don't know if you can handle that, dude.
I'm just gonna melt my face
off.
Last
time I did this, it involved a strikeout.
Yeah, it's a little narnar.
All right. Well, here's the thing. We're live right now. We are live somewhere on the interwebs. Let me see here. What's up, everybody? The Beer Dad, Justin Allen, and we are back in the saddle here recording a podcast. There's Soto. We got Jimmy from the Craft Lounge. We got Ryan from Brewcaipa. Brandon over here, Brando from the Craft Lounge. As you can see, he's up to his shenanigans. He's getting people to do some shotguns here. We're going to do some shotguns to honor Josh. We're actually recording the podcast right now while we're live on Instagram. So what's up, everybody, on Instagram?
The Graham!
There he is.
I have a bit of something to say real quick.
Wait, where's my...
You
want to
do it too?
No, it's fine. I can record.
Okay.
All right. Here we go.
So I would like to take this moment to say Josh was my shotgun buddy on the show. And so this one's for him.
This one's for Josh.
This one's for Josh. So we got Joe. Not Joe. Joe, we already had the Joe. Jay, that's what I meant to say. Jay, Ingrid. And we got Myra. And
Alex.
Alex.
There he is.
And so we're going to shotgun a beer. Actually, I'm going to get down there with you
guys. I need
you
to get down there so you can be on tape right here.
Put your keys away.
There you go.
We're going to double it up right now, dude.
I see that. So we're live on the Craft Lounge Instagram, as well as the Beer Dad Instagram.
All right, you guys all ready?
Yeah. Oh, feedback. Ready? Feedback loop.
1, 2, 3.
Jeez.
A little bit of bork.
That was impressive.
There's the Beer Dad. He always shows everybody else, but he doesn't show himself. There
Cheers,
he is.
Good job, Jimmy.
Damn it, Jimmy.
Is that going through the mixer?
I love the delay on it when we're doing it both at the same time.
I forgot to do my shotgun. It's not a shotgun, but it's a chug. I'll be back home.
Thank you, guys.
Oh,
Got it.
Thank you.
Get up.
For Josh.
There you go. That's awesome. So thank you, Instagram, for joining in on our chug, brought to you by Mr. Tons and Kettles, Brandon Gray, Craft
Cheers,
Lounge.
Mate.
That chug was, or that, sorry, not chug, shotgun was for Joshua Kunkle, our dear friend, the Broodman, who, by the way, we have always, continuing here on the BeerDad and Brewed podcast, there will always be a pint poured for our good friend Joshua Kunkle.
Always.
That's right.
So what we've been doing here on the BeerDad and Brew podcast is we have been sampling some recipes made by some local breweries with Josh's recipe. And so far we had some triple IPA, which is called Joe's Revenge, one of Josh's famous recipes, that was made by this man right over there.
Sorry, I'm still trying to text Juan.
So there is Ryan Blondell, head brewer of Brewcaipa in Ucaipa, California.
10-4.
There you go. So he did a great job on that triple IPA. So if you guys want to try it, head on over to Brewcaipa, Ucaipa, California, and ask for some Joe's Revenge. It's on tap right now.
Sweet.
And the next beer that we tried, where's that can? Let me see that can. Hand me that can right there. So the next beer that we tried was near and dear to the beer dad's heart because right here, Coachella Valley Brewing. This is Kunkles Remedies. This is a double IPA with turmeric, ginger, and coconut. And this is based in part of the beer that Josh and I made together, Mo-in-Law's Hazy Home Remedies. So this is really awesome that they took a chance on this. And the general consensus here at the table is it's actually really good. So I'm really happy. Thank you, Coachella Valley Brewing, for making this beer. If you guys want to try it, head on out to the desert, Coachella Valley Brewing Company, and ask for some Kunkles Remedies, double IPA with turmeric, ginger, and coconut. Absolutely fabulous. What did you think of it, Brandon?
I thought it was pretty nice. You know, I remember the original.
He was hiding back there.
I remember the original. And
the OG.
It's an improvement, but I
yes
I like yeah, both
there you go,
both are beers, that is true.
All right, and so Jimmy, you liked it?
I liked it a lot.
I liked it a lot.
Listen to that echo
compared to the original, which I hope never comes to exist ever again. It's fucking great, dude. It's great. I get the idea, dude. And I love it. And I told Josh to his face, too, dude. I love you, bro, but please don't make that beer again. But it's been perfected. I think it's great. I like it. I like it a lot. I like what they did with it, honestly.
Awesome.
Shout out to CBB on that one.
Beautiful. Soto, what did you think of your health food over there?
It was delicious. You know, it's definitely going to help with my high blood pressure. So that's all I was worried about.
That's what I
did. You know, I was like, this inflammation in my feet got to go.
I love it. Oh, man. Ryan, what are your thoughts on it?
I like it. I like it a lot. I think, like I said, I want to see maybe do it without the coconut, but I can drink it.
There you go. I can drink it.
I'm a fan of that coconut. Dude, I like it a lot.
Yeah. So... I think in case you didn't know.
No, I agree. I'm just curious what it would be like without it.
I got you.
The inner brewer in me is like, hey.
I want to see.
Awesome. Well, Instagram, thanks for letting us jump on. We appreciate you guys. Come on down to the Craft Lounge, Beaumont, California, and come check us out. We're live on stage right now. We're still recording, so if you want to come say hi, come on down. Cheers.
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 Cheerio.
Cheerio.
Cheerio. All
right.
Wow. All right. That was fun.
Right.
So we're moving on.
We're moving
intervention
on.
Over.
Like we reset.
Did you get a hold of Mr.?
No, I sent him like 3 text messages with the... Right.
I'm going to try calling him. We're just going to go with it.
The brewer from Babes.
So go ahead and grab that Babes can, if you will.
Oh, Babe.
Oh, baby.
This is for Chris. You remind me of the Babe.
That was old Babes.
Babe with the power.
Hey, 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 I didn't release myself to be on their can.
That's what I said. Yo, I didn't either. What the
fuck? Easy, babe. Easy, babe.
I didn't release myself.
Someone jocked one of our old MySpace pictures.
What's going on here?
Right.
They even got a nude picture of me. That's kind of hard to come by.
Oh, you're the one with the...
Your call has been forwarded to an...
Epic fail, Juan.
Oh, do you think his phone died? Like his battery died?
Maybe.
I'll text his girlfriend.
Well, try that. See.
Whoa. I want nothing to do with that, Ryan.
Hey, desperate times, desperate measures.
I want nothing.
We need to have the Babes.
Can we do,
I want to get back to Soto's
Kunkle
birthday
Dunkle
suit.
Then?
Well, I want to get.
Oh, yeah. So anyway.
Yeah.
So.
I don't know. They didn't get as many creases.
So the label, the label.
That's off of his fucking OnlyFans.
Yeah.
As Soto's OnlyFans.
OnlyFans at A-Soto. A-Soto 5, OnlyFans. So, I made my own website, OnlyCans, so we're just doing
for the
cans only.
So they know what the hell we're talking about.
It says OnlyHams.
On the Babes Crowler label, there's three naked pigs.
Yeah. And I'm the big one, obviously.
No, dude, you're the one with the butt poking out.
Oh yeah, I definitely got the butt. That is a little pork butt.
Little pig.
I would say that's kind of like me, I guess. I'm like sub, like trying to chug.
Oh, man.
Chug me?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'd chug me.
Chug on this.
I'd chug me real hard.
I'd chug me real hard.
It puts barbecue sauce on the skin.
Shut You know, it's funny you say that.
It puts the rub on the skin. Or else it gets the sauce.
It's funny you say that.
Just wrap me in foil, baby.
Puts butter on the skin.
Because you said that, we're watching my good friend on Instagram, We Are Parched.
Oh, yeah.
Why are we watching this?
Yeah. You'll see. Oh, yeah. What's up, We Are Parched, brother? Cheers.
Oh, yeah. He's got to do the tuck. If he doesn't do the tuck.
Oh, he's got
it. Well, that's the whole point.
Yeah. All right,
man. That's cool, man.
There he is. Here he comes. He's going to say it.
Do it.
We Are Parched. I love you, buddy. This
Would
is great.
Would you chug me? I chug me. I chug me real hard.
Yeah. This is good. This is great A. This is great A.
No tuck.
You got. Tuck. It's all right. If he had a tuck while he chugged, game over.
So
it takes real talent. Though.
Go ahead and go on
watch this.
Instagram.
It
go ahead and go on
it. He's talking, guys. He's
right, yeah. Head over to Instagram and follow my good friend. We Are Parched. He's a chugger. That's what he does. He's got lots of following on Instagram. He's a cool dude. His chugs are very innovative, as you could see.
Yeah.
So I definitely appreciate it, though. He's got like so many costumes, but he's got a Hulk Hogan costume with like the blow up muscles, and it's so funny, nice. Dude. And he does like Hogan chugs. That's it's so hilarious. But yeah, check him out. We Are Parched. All right. Did you get a hold of the girlfriend?
Send a message.
Hopefully.
How about we do Kunkle Dunkle?
Yeah, we can do Devon.
Let me try calling Devon.
Cocoa butter?
Yeah. Let's rub some cocoa butter on
your
skin.
There's nothing wrong with that.
Kunkle Dunkle. The Kunkle Dunkle.
Let's get us just some night. Let's get some moon tans. Let's get some moon tans.
Yo, have you ever honestly
ooh, the FaceTime
cocoa butter? Because you want to see what it tastes like?
No.
Dang, we're going hard. Put me on FaceTime. I wanted to.
For sure.
I wanted to.
Same thing, because I've wanted to drink Fabuloso, too.
Oh, no.
I've never done that. It looks delicious. What are you talking about?
Why did, when you say that, the Fabuloso, did I smell Fabuloso at the same exact
time? Yeah.
No, is that just me, or am I having a fucking stroke?
There he is. Why is Fabuloso, go by, like,
Devon!
What's up, Devon? What's up?
We're gonna drink
sorry, I know I just texted you, and we were going to do one, but his phone is dead right now, so we're waiting for his girlfriend to get us on her phone, so.
Oh, Juan?
Yeah.
Okay. No worries. I want to be a part of it. I just saw your text. I was like, oh shoot.
It's live. We're on.
We're on.
Devon, you are on the podcast.
Hold on.
So there's Brandon.
Yo.
We've got Soto over here.
What's up,
Ingrid and Jimmy.
Hi, Ingrid.
And you know that beautiful mug over there.
I know you.
I know you too.
Oh,
We're going to get into some Kunkle Dunkle right now.
We are going to get into some Kunkle Dunkle.
Hey, look at, there we go. You can check it out right here. I got mine.
Oh,
he was prepared. Look at that.
Yeah. Right, sorry, it's not pretty. It's not pretty. I'm not a pretty place like you guys are.
That's all right.
Amongst awesome friends.
We're going to shotgun this one.
No, we're not shotgunning that
dude,
one.
Dude, what?
Brandon, cool, Brandon just got a bunch of people from the crowd here to shotgun with him. And, yeah, that's where he's at right now.
Let me go sit at this table over here.
All right.
All right, so...
crack it open, baby.
So, yeah, for the sound creeps, come on. Let me
Here's
get
the sound creeps.
So,
ASMR?
ASMR, baby.
Oh!
Epic fail.
You had one job, Brandon. One job.
It's not my fault. Desert Beer doesn't know how to crawl or a beer.
Oh.
I'm just fucking with you.
What happened?
I'm going
to
make up for it.
I'm fucking with you.
It didn't make it to the... He just did it too slow.
There
that's
we
all.
Go.
All right.
I did.
Job, yeah, it went a little slow. Oh, man, I can smell it already right when you opened it.
That was Brandon's chug breath, dude.
That is Brandon's chug breath.
It was turmeric and coconut and hops. Yeah.
So we just got done having the turmeric ginger beer from Coachella. Have you had that yet?
I have. I have had that. Actually, our good friend right there, Ryan, brought it to me.
There you go.
I did. As soon as they made it available, I brought him a.
What did you think?
He was on his way back. It's good. The flavors are way different than I thought, because I never actually had that beer before. I never even knew that existed.
Yeah.
I was like, wow. The turmeric's a little big, but I don't remember because I never had it, so I had no idea.
All right.
But it's a pretty good beer. It's actually fairly, I think it's pretty interesting in terms of the flavor content, because when you get those kind of spices in a beer, it's different. It's way different. You're not expecting it.
Definitely interesting.
Can I fill you up here?
Yes, please, Ryan. I'm going to have Ryan pour me some of this beautiful Kunkle Dunkel.
So I had this a couple weeks back. And
this is why I love Josh, though. So, you know, I miss the guy.
Because
this beer is, just to give you guys a little context about this. This is the Uncle Kunkle Dunkel. But the interesting thing apart this beer is that it's a Dunkelweizen. The interesting thing apart of Dunkelweizen, as we all know, we should know, is Dunkelweizen translates as dark wheat. There is no wheat in this beer. And that's because Josh designed it this way.
That's right.
I love him for that, because he always used to make beers that were different than what was conceptually there.
Right.
So he would make them different. And so this beer is, although a very, very delicious beer, it is not technically a Dunkelweizen, but it is a very delicious dark German ale, or dark German lager, sorry.
It's not a Dunkelweizen, but it is an Uncle Kunkle Dunkel.
Yes,
that's what it is. Yeah. So this is really cool. Cheers. Cheers to Devin there too.
Cheers, Devin.
I've had this and it is freaking bomb, so I'm excited to have it again.
So this particular recipe is something that Jimmy was always pushing Josh to make,
dude,
just because of his name.
Begging, really good, dude.
Yeah.
How could you not make a Kunkle Dunkle, dude?
I mean, that's.
Yeah, so, isn't that the best name ever?
Jimmy Bimmy.
Hell yeah.
Jimmy Dunkle.
So he.
I'm really upset that my last name is Blondell, because.
Blondell.
I'm pigeonholed into blonde.
You have to make a Blondell now that there's a Ryan Blondell. So.
I'm surprised you haven't yet.
Right?
I make one every week.
But you don't call it that.
I know you do, but it's not yours. It's not Blondell's Blondell.
Boulevard Blondell.
There you go. So the cool thing about this, Devin, and I want to thank you again, is you let me be a part of making this beer. I was able to come in, and it was really cool to be there with you and Chance. And Laramie, and and can't forget Lennox, the cute little assistant brewer. Man, she knew what she was doing. She kind of directed everybody, I think.
Yeah.
It was good to have you guys.
Yeah, it was awesome. Thank you. And so, being a part of this, just because you know Josh was such a good friend of mine and my co-host here on the podcast, it was just an amazing time to get together with some friends and people that he thought very highly of. I mean, he loved you. He loved your brewery. He's very supportive of your brewery. It was just a good time, and I had fun. And the beer came out amazing. We had this beer at Josh's memorial, and the keg got killed quick. quit
dude,
status.
It disappeared fast.
Yeah. Well, it's funny. I actually told the story. So when you went, you were getting ready to leave. We had just tapped your keg right before you were going to leave. And you went to go get your new dad car, right? The family wagon.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And
the,
so
I was there
with your wife and, you know, playing with the baby. And then she goes, I think our keg's over there are ready to take home. That's perfect time. I'm like, there's no way that's a keg. Did we have another one? Maybe it's another one. And sure as shit, it was the keg. I'm like, oh my God, we went through the whole keg already. Wow.
So
they loved it.
It was very quick.
Yeah. So, and it's a damn good beer. So good job.
I agree.
To everybody involved. Yeah. What do you guys think? Yeah.
I appreciate you, Justin. Thank you.
So this is my favorite out of all the Josh tribute beers so far. Yeah. I absolutely love this beer. It's so.
Yeah, it's amazing.
I don't know how to say it other than like it's so him.
Yeah.
It literally. Like, when I think about the beer that he brewed, it's like seriously, this is it. Like,
it totally is.
Dude, like all the beers that we talked about over the years, like, you know, he's a huge like. He's traditionalist, but like you said, he liked to put a lot of spins on like different styles.
Yeah.
So just kind of make it his own, which I appreciate so much. It's kind of funny. It kind of reminds me of like he always talks about how much he loves Anchor. And if Anchor were to make like a, you know, like a Dunkel, it's just kind of like it's very reminiscent of how it would be.
Yeah, it is.
You could definitely tell where his influences came from, but he was so creative and so,
yeah,
he's so good.
Yeah. He was so fun, his recipes, he would always tweak them up slightly just to make it work, and I loved it. It's like, and we'd always, like, whenever I used to have the big brews with them, I always remember them doing that. We're like, oh, shoot, we're out of this. He's like, well, this is really close. Let's just go ahead and use it.
He did that with the Irish Red that we, the last beer that we made together.
Straight up brew MacGyver.
Yep.
Yeah, dude.
He's like, we don't have this, but if I combine this and this, it's going to simulate that flavor.
Yeah, you did it. Yeah. Exactly.
Dude, it was funny.
Like, if I use something a little bit darker and then using a little lighter, it'll work out just fine. I loved it, dude.
Oh, yeah, dude.
Like, you don't have, like, 60, but you use, like, 120 and 20 or 40 to, like, make that combo. And I'm like, you're the best.
Yeah,
I love
you, dude.
That's awesome.
Brew MacGyver.
Well, this is great. So, Devon, Desert Beer Company. Palm Desert. South of the 10 freeway. It is on tap right now, correct?
Yes, it is on tap.
It'll
be on draft. It'll be on draft for a little while. We probably have, because we got a good netting on it, we probably will have it on draft for at least another month.
Okay.
Awesome.
Unless people come by and drink the heck out of it right here.
That's what you need to do. Yeah. Look at shameful plug, Desert Beer Company.
Desert Beer. Go there and drink some.
Hey, by the way, I really like the fact that you guys are like right next to a gym. That's like the funniest shit ever. Like,
dude, there's like three gyms. You're gonna blow your mind.
Yeah.
There's like three gyms and there's a jujitsu.
Dude.
Dojo right
there's one like literally like right there on the corner.
Yeah.
So I can imagine like everybody like getting hammered after
the funniest thing that happened at his brewery with the gyms was his brewer is a Marine that won't accept that he's out of shape. And they all of them were running by in the back with like a CrossFit thing, and they had like these bags on. And Chance runs over in his brewing boots and grabs a sack of grain, 50, and runs with these like 120-pound girls that are running around like
yeah, hoorah.
The, oh,
hoorah.
Dude, he came back, was almost dead, but he did it. And all
those, like,
and all they all came in for beers later that night because they thought that was so funny.
They did. And he was like, he's like, dude, he's like, I've felt most alive I've felt in a long time. he was strapping with 55 pounds and walked. He ran or jogged. I would say jogged around, but that's heavy. He
that's
jogged
awesome.
Around the a building, you know?
Oh, man. Chance,
but
you're crazy,
cool.
buddy. And we also got a shout-out to Chance, because Chance brewed some beer up at Yucca Public House. He made Mexican lager, right?
Yes.
Mexicanus. Pseudo-Mexicanus, we called it.
Pseudo-Mexicanus. So is there any of that still left, or did you blow through that?
To be honest with you, I think that actually is just gone. We do have the brown. The brown they made, Laramie made the brown. It's called...
it's got dates in it, right?
Well, no, it's figs in it. It's
figs, that's right.
God, what's the name of it? I'm sorry. I should be knowing this on the top of my head, but we are selling four packs of it in the tap room. There are four packs there for sale. And it is a fig brown. It is a fig brown ale. I know that for a fact. So definitely come down and get some, because they don't really have a whole lot left. There's like another like five or six. The last time I saw, there's like five or six more four packs in there. Okay.
And that's from Yucca Public House.
That's from Yucca Public House. Yep.
Good stuff. Shout out to Chance and Laramie.
Awesome. Laramie used to make beers with Josh all back the in the day before I even knew Josh.
Yep.
And they used to make beers in the Cove, in La Quinta Cove. And that was like kind of one of them in a sense. She mentioned like having made a brown with figs, and that was like one of the things that made her want to do that. So
awesome.
That was the cool part, you know.
That's dope.
Oh, figment of your imagination.
Figment, there it is.
Love that name.
Figment, F-I-G-M-E-N-T, figment of your imagination. So that's definitely it. I was like, I knew it. I knew it's in my head right now. I had it. but yeah, she made that. That was one of the ones. So like I said, he made Pseudo Mexicanus.
Okay.
He also made Pseudo Magnum, which was like it was a different version, but had dry hop with Magnum.
Okay.
So there was like two different versions that he made. He did it regular and then he did it dry hop. So
nice.
But those are, I think, are fully sold out on those two. And then the Figment is the only one left.
Awesome.
So cool. Definitely come by and grab a 4 pack. We have them in the tap room cooler in the corner of the room. Definitely come grab a pack for yourself and enjoy in his honor. And then the proceeds from that are pretty much going to the family. So again, we're still collecting money there.
Awesome.
We still have his memoriam on the counter, and we're taking in tips from that. So anybody that has extra change, throw it in there. We're still collecting for that too, okay?
Awesome. Thank you, Devin, for doing that. That's really cool.
Until we sell out of that beer, sell out of my beer, the Uncle Kunkle Dunkel, the one we made version for him, we're going to keep that going all the way until then, okay?
Awesome. And how do you feel about continuing making that in the future? Like maybe, you know, around his birthday or his anniversary?
Yes.
Or
that's what I wanted to do. I was like, at least once a year, I was figuring on making it on his birthday. That'd be fine. I'd love to do that. I would love to do that. I want to make more of his beers, you know, not regularly, but irregularly. We'll have his beers on.
Okay.
Just in his honor, I'd love to have them. So yeah, definitely. I love the Kunkle Dunkle, especially around, well, technically I'd be like to make it, and then we can actually even maybe lager a little longer in a sense to have it longer. So, but I do think that it'd be nice to have it on his birthday. It'd be awesome.
Awesome. Well, I'm down. Hit me up. I'll come out there.
Yeah.
And help stir the pot.
Stir the pot.
Yeah. help get that mash going.
Right? The beer dad's good at stirring the pot, right?
Honestly, dude,
or
I think
beans mashed.
Just always milling is always appreciated. Like, anytime you want to mill.
Well, you know what? It was really cool though, because he had all the grain already milled and ready for us.
Oh,
right?
You're so nice.
He was super prepared. Like we were like ready to go.
I wanted to make sure it was more streamlined so we can get to the meat of it.
Yeah, that's super legit.
You know, because I think that there's a lot to that. And yeah, we don't have an auger system like Ryan. Oh my gosh.
Sorry. I paid for that. Like,
yeah, for real.
No, but we you know, it's a labor of love. You know, a lot more labor than love, but. But we enjoy it, and I do appreciate it, and I love having people there help out, and I love having people there to help to commemorate something like this, which is amazing. So I do appreciate you guys always.
Well, thank you again, Devin, for obviously being a good friend to Josh, but helping us in honor, keep his memory alive, because he was such a good person. And this beer means a lot to me just because I got to be a part of making it. So that's really cool. And like I said,
I'm back for more.
Yeah, I'm ready. Yeah, ready for more. Everybody needs to go out to Desert Beer Company in Palm Desert and drink up the Uncle Kunkle Dunkel. I don't know. Maybe. I don't know if you got some extra kegs around. I don't think Jimmy might want to procure a keg or two.
Yeah, I'll do a sixer for Jimmy if he wants one.
There you go. We'll get some Uncle Kunkle Dunkle here so people don't have to drive so far.
I actually have a sixer if you want a sixer.
There you go.
Is it?
You want one, Jimmy?
Okay.
Yeah, done.
Sixer
done.
I didn't know this turned into a sales call all of a sudden.
I'm like that middleman, you know.
I can't hear. So how big is this kid now?
Yeah.
Oh, how big is the kid?
Yeah.
Lennox
is getting big. Lennox is getting big, and also the family's growing, right, Devon?
What?
The family is growing. That's all I'm coming.
One on the way.
Oh, dude, slow it. Dude, get a TV. Buy a TV.
One in the pocket.
Brew more beer or something, bro. Do something else with your time, dude.
I got to make way more beer.
See, what he's doing is he's lining up all his assistant brewers so he doesn't have to work anymore.
See, Justin knows what's going on.
Yeah, it's more work at home.
I have my labor force coming in.
That's right. You don't have to pay those guys.
Exactly.
Child labor is not illegal.
It's called, it's a workman program. It's fine.
That's right.
Job security.
No, I'm just going to buy you a TV, Devin. I'm going to send you a TV, bro.
A video game or something.
Yeah, something, dude. Something.
Get him a Nintendo Switch.
We're in the fucking brewery all the time, dude. So.
January, right? Is that what you said? January?
End of January.
Jimmy's going to order beers.
Find out what it is.
You're waiting until the day, right?
We're waiting till the day.
He's going to wait till the day of birth to find out if it's a boy or a girl.
Yeah, we thought.
We got some gear for him. We got some craft lounge gear.
Yeah, we do have. We got some craft lounge baby gear. Coming. So
we'll send it out to you. I'll send it out to you, Devin.
Definitely.
Maybe Ryan can take it out to you or something. So.
Why am I the middleman between Desert Beer and the craft beer line?
I gotta come by soon, Jimmy. I'll come by and hang out with you in a while.
There you go. Well, you're hanging out with us here now while we...
Definitely come by.
We're drinking this Uncle Kunkle Dunkel. It's a really good beer. You have it there on tap. Devon, thank you so much again for brewing it and having it out at your brewery. You're awesome.
Heck yeah.
And brew more, dude. Stop having kids, bro.
Yeah, stop having kids. That's right.
His wife's brewing, not me, bro. I'm brewing my own stuff.
Yeah, it's your brew that's causing
the
kids,
the problem. I was
kidding. You're brewing something up.
There you go.
So. No, man, keep brewing.
Guys, thank you.
Yeah. All right, well, Devon.
It's baby brew.
I would say we'll tell you to stay away from the wife, but you don't have to worry about having another one because you're already having another one, so you're good to go.
Hey, come January, I'm ordering a shit ton of beer, bro. So
there you go.
Just stay in the brewery.
I'm thinking of you, Devon.
I'm thinking of you, brother.
There you go. Yeah. All right, brother. Thanks for joining us, and we'll be in touch soon, okay? All right, cheers.
Thanks, guys.
Have a good night.
Cheers, brother.
Have a good night.
You too.
You know Devin had his pants off the whole time, dude. He didn't have any pants
for
on.
For sure.
Dude. He didn't have any pants on, dude.
I think that's what you do during virtual, right?
We're virtual right now, bro, and my pants are on.
Well, kind of. Right, I'm looking over there. They're like half down.
We're on it. Like, there's people here.
You
like,
don't gotta lie.
And...
I don't give a fuck.
You don't gotta lie to kick it. All of our pants have been off this whole time.
What are pants? What are pants?
What are
awesome.
Pants?
Well, man, I like that Uncle Kunkle Dunkel.
Dude, me too.
Is there any more?
The Kunkle Dunkle.
Oh, you drank it all.
I'm afraid.
Oh, yeah, you did pour the rest.
I'll tell you what. The cool thing is that I think sometimes there's nothing more refreshing than a traditional style, like something that reminds you of the old stuff that kind of got us into drinking beer.
And when it rhymes, it makes it better.
Exactly.
Yeah.
When it rhymes.
The Uncle Kunkle Dunkel.
When it rhymes, it shines. What?
When it rhymes,
it chimes.
When it rhymes, there's dimes. So I don't know.
Well, what's funny is, I do spend a lot of time at Devin's place. He's on my way home. He's literally one exit over.
Dangerous.
And it's funny. Like, I've been in there a couple times, and people will order something. Something gets misheard. It gets loud. And that's the wee heavy.
Sure.
I know.
We know. But what's funny is like people will accidentally order that beer and they're like, oh, I don't like dark beer. And I'll be like, dude, just try it. Try that beer. And 9 times out of 10, they end up ordering another pint.
Well, yeah.
It's an awesome beer. And shout out to Devon for that one. That one came out fantastic.
Totally. And shout out to Josh for creating that recipe.
Heck yeah.
Fuck yeah.
Fucking fuck yeah.
Yeah.
Fuck yeah.
America.
It's just cool because I remember.
No, I was thinking of that. Oh, I was thinking
right.
of
Team America. I remember talking to him when he was like coming up the recipe, and I was like, yeah, that's so freaking cool. And we've been talking about it for a long time.
Oh, I begged
on
him,
the podcast.
I was begging him, dude,
about
please
make
a
Kunkle
Dunkel. Please. For the like love that, of God, make a Kunkle.
That's literally how it was derived
and
from
happened.
A name.
Yeah, exactly.
That's so
you know,
awesome.
The crazy part is that last batch, which was, I think, version 3 for him that he made, the third time he had made a Dunkel, the one that we had that he finally brought. And it came out freaking phenomenal.
Yeah.
I would say that this was extremely close to it. Like, I mean, obviously we followed the recipe, to the T, obviously just much scaled up, much higher. I mean, Devon had to do a couple tweaks obviously, cause on the production side, a little bit different.
Yeah.
Yeah, dude, it's so similar and crushable. Like you said, like that's that, just that straight, like, you know, sometimes we talk about, we just want to drink lager,
right?
You know, we don't want to, like, yeah, triple IPs are great. That freaking beer was phenomenal that Ryan made. But you can't drink like 6 or 7 of those. You'd be like,
you could.
Soda over here.
Unless you're by the pool. Unless you're by the pool.
Yo,
challenge
you
accepted.
You already know this, though. Like, welcome to life. Welcome to the craft lounge. Honestly, that's
right.
All we drink is
lagers,
like
yeah.
Lagered beers, dude. Like, for
every
the most part.
Every time I see Jimmy,
he's got
that tremor in his hand.
Oh, yeah.
Are you saying I'm on my shakes? Like, I'm shaking all the time? Or something?
No. Not the Parkinson's. We're talking tremor beer.
Intervention.
And here we go. We're talking about tremor. Oh, I mean, Parkinson's. Oh, fuck.
Oh, Jingo.
You're not that old yet, Jimmy.
Sorry, Michael J. Sorry, Michael J.
So Michael J. Fox.
Pinchy tremors.
Did you want to go? We heavy or did you want to go?
Well, yeah,
because
let's have a little break in case Juan somehow charges
okay.
his phone. So let's do some of your wee heavy. Let's do a side by side comparison.
Oh,
this is your wee heavy, and then
let's
we also
it,
have.
I didn't know I was
going
to have to go head to head against Josh here.
Well,
guys.
Josh would appreciate that.
So I did not know that a wee heavy was going to be here. I just brought it because it's
wee heavy.
It's one of my favorite beers that I have at Brewcaipa. Personally, I enjoy drinking the wee heavies. I think they're I like style.
I would say it just got
is
a
it
wee
wheat?
Heavier.
Is it wheat heavy or wee heavy?
It's wee heavy, like
wheat.
We, you and I,
heavy.
Wee heavy. Yeah.
Yes, that is the best.
With extra E.
Yeah. I'm a heavy boy. That's why I like that.
Can we not do the Cardi B, please?
Cardi B.
No, we're fucking like doing monkey calls.
Let's go.
What's a hearty?
Oh, I thought you were doing the.
No.
Oh, Kurt.
No, that's yeah. Oh, Kurt. We weren't doing this.
No, you did that well, Ryan.
You
did that
very
well.
Very well.
You did that real
shit all you want, bro.
I feel like
you
practiced that. I feel like you practiced that.
Well, there's some Instagram following.
I want to see what's on your playlist right now at this point, dude. It's like
it's a lot of bluegrass.
Okay,
all right. Oh, Kurt.
Oh, Kurt. Oh, Kurt. Never heard that in bluegrass, bro.
No.
Hey, they boundaries. They,
oh,
they,
he's the stuttering. He knows that this is the Cardi B.
Fuck, dude.
We caught you.
Okay. I actually can't
it's
name.
Okay,
I can name one song, I think, from her.
I know you're probably gonna say "WAP" because it's your favorite movie song.
It's a good video.
There you go. See?
Hey. Did you do the challenge?
What's the WAP challenge?
What's the WAP challenge?
You know, dancing to it. You do the dance moves.
Oh no, I don't know anything about that. I'm not hip to social media.
I don't know. WAP, wings and pizza?
Yay.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Wings and pizza. I do the WAP challenge every week.
I am at
this podcast. Going straight WAPing.
Yeah. I am Italian, guys, just so you know.
Oh,
so there's no pineapple on your pizza?
You've been WAPing all your life.
Hey.
That's all good, dude. That's cool.
Different kind of WAP, bro.
What? Yeah, that's a different WAP, yeah.
Oh,
Did we just get in trouble again?
We're still going. An hour and 7 minutes. We are still alive. FCC has not shut us down.
All of a sudden, Justin talks. He's been on Pornhub for the last 5 minutes.
Whenever Soda talks, we get in trouble.
I know. Thanks, Soda. Thanks for messing us up.
Sorry. You know, I gotta turn it down for the kids in the audience.
I was gonna say, I got a tortilla. I was like, what the fuck?
You
didn't share?
Yeah. Flip a greedy mother.
Yeah, yeah. I was hoping the dudes were gonna make me some flatbreads in there. That's why I brought the tortillas with me.
What's this?
I don't know what's happening right now.
Yeah, I feel like I'm about to work out or something. That never happens.
Oh, this thing is funny too.
Listen,
is this the Backstreet Boys?
No, but we're having Wee Heavy, so I thought we needed some Heavy D and the Boys.
There you go.
Heavy D and the Boys?
Yeah,
dude.
Heavy D.
Can't fuck with Heavy D.
Should put on Fat Boys.
R.I.P. Heavy D.
R.I.P. Heavy D.
Dang, and Biz Markie.
That was a Biz Markie, dude. You should put some Biz Markie on.
Dang. So, that was a bummer.
He was such a good friend. I mean, he just... Too soon. Too soon.
And we got a shout-out to Muñecas. Oh, yeah. Ceci's here. From
absolutely. And just perfect timing because she probably didn't know there was an extra microphone. Just ran.
Got her.
Got
him.
Hi, Ceci.
Hey, how are you guys? Ceci.
Delightful. So, yeah, welcome. We're doing a show. We're honoring Josh, and we're having some of Josh's brews. We're taking a little break right here from some of the beers that have been brewed by the breweries, and this beer was brewed by that guy over there at Brewcaipa. This is a Wee Heavy, and then we're going to have a Wee Heavy that was actually made by Josh and Brandon. So, it's Wee Heavy. You don't have a headset on right now, but in the background we have Heavy D and the Boys playing.
Oh, okay.
Cheers, there you
gentlemen.
Go. Cheers.
Cheers, everybody.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Dude, we should just like pipe the music into that. Pipe the podcast into that.
Oh man, that is tasty. That is really good. That is really good.
What is this one called?
That's right now we are very unoriginal with the name right now. It's just Are We Heavy. Yeah. So we had a beer.
That's it. Are We Heavy?
Yeah. Are We Heavy? Yeah, we had a.
Are we Heavy?
No, are. Like, question. Are We Heavy?
You should call it. Here you go. I got a name. Are We Heavy? We Heavy and the Boys.
I had a name, something around like We All Heavy. Uh-huh. And then they didn't like the name. Anyway, so it's right now it's just on tap as We Heavy. But we used to have a beer called Wee Bit of Rum. And that was a rum-infused...
I have had that beer.
Wee Heavy. And I retooled the recipe a little bit more towards what I like. And then we are barrel-aging the same beer in a whiskey barrel that we soaked in rum. So I'll have a wee bit of rum coming back out, but more of a traditional style.
It's good. It's good.
How about Heavy Wee and the Boys?
Yeah. Isn't that what I said? No, I said we heavy
and
the boys.
Yeah, you fucked it all up. You fucked it all up. That's cool though.
Heavy wee and the boys.
Heavy wee wee?
Heavy wee wee and...
Heavy wee wee.
Heavy wee wee.
Now, when you're talking about a heavy wee wee, that's something totally different.
Heavy wee wee and the back problems. I don't know.
I could be wrong, but I think the dudes are bringing us a pizza right now.
Oh, hell no.
Give the dill dudes.
Hell no. Oh, hell no.
The dudes.
So he's giving us a piece of the bearded clam pie.
Did he just ask if he wanted some clam pie?
Clam.
He's got
clam
pie.
Bearded clam pie.
Oh, it's very good.
That's right.
It's hot.
Clammy.
There it is.
A little clammy.
So, real quick, shameless plug. Dough Dudes Pizza
is off the hook.
Dough Dudes Pizza off the hook. They are here at the Craft Lounge tonight. They're here every Thursday night.
You got to get it,
dude. Pies. Amazing pies.
Amazing.
My good friend Dave would say one bite. Everybody knows the rules. Take a bite,
dude. Don't
lick it and pass it.
Don't hand a pizza.
Maybe
in front of a fat guy and say don't eat the ones with bacon on it. Holy shit!
All right, so
that's how we get them.
What am I doing here? Don't eat the ones with bacon.
Why am we going to put a pizza with bacon in front of a fat guy?
The clam comes through. I think the bacon drowns the clam out, man.
Okay.
Yeah. And it was a lot more saltier with
the little clammy.
The pork and the clam sometimes. Yeah.
We're going to have some clam pizza, Ceci? You
know? No, not today.
I figure when the pork and the clam get together, all good things happen.
That's true. That is when the best things happen.
Hey, is this a white sauce, too?
What is this?
Are you saying when a clam eats pork?
That's a wee heavy.
That's a special dough dude. That's a dough dude special sauce.
Are you saying when a clam eats pork?
Is that
people?
Thank you. Hi, Jay.
Jay.
Is that the wee heavy?
Have a good night, bang.
For Brian.
Yes. Beautiful. So this is Wee Heavy.
Is that mine or yours?
Yeah, that's yours.
Okay, cool.
Yeah, that's the end of yours.
Sweet.
And
that's it.
I should have
bought
you more pizza earlier.
That's good.
We still have plenty of beer, so you're more welcome.
And I'm getting more spiciness on this.
Yeah, so I put a little red pepper flake on it.
Love it.
Yeah, so it comes through a little bit more, huh?
Love it. Yeah.
I want to put more clam juice in it, I think, next time.
Yeah.
I think it needs more clam juice. It's not though, dude. It needs more clam juice.
It needs more
clam juice.
I need more cowbell, but not quite the same.
More of Brian's mom's juice.
Yeah, you're right. I'm sorry. Brian's mom actually grew those clams in France.
What are they, like, mating snails, too?
Here, here, wait. Wow. Get that piece right there. Yeah, it's got some clam on it.
Great job, Dough Dudes.
Take some bites.
Attaboy, Dough Dudes.
Thank you.
What was the OG and the final? Do you remember on this one?
These are for Nico, so I'm glad you said no. I was offering it to you. I know she's like, is it good? You taste clam? Not as much? No?
No, I'm getting an aftertaste of it. Yeah,
yeah, a little bit?
A little bit.
I think I'm going to fucking... 17.2
extra clam cheese.
Thanks, guys.
And final gravity's 2.5.
Oh, wow.
Give Hugo. Did you give Hugo a sip of that yet?
I think poured him one.
No, yeah. He has his own.
Oh,
I am not sharing.
No sharing.
Not today.
No.
It's we heavy.
We heavy Hugo.
And then,
it pairs well with the clam
juice.
It's
really good.
It's a Scottish ale.
Is this a new shirt that I'm looking at right now?
Yeah.
Holy crap!
Yes.
The beautiful Sassy is on a T-shirt. It says La Muñeca, and then I can't. My eyes are horrible.
So it's like a loteria card.
Yeah, it's like loteria. And it says satisfy your cravings. Dude, that is dope. I can't wait to get one of them.
That's the newest card. That's the newest card to your deck.
Is it? Is it?
So it was a test run, and people are liking
it.
People are asking for it. So
you know, Josh, we're honoring him tonight on this episode. He would have absolutely loved that shirt. I know because he had the El Borracho shirt.
Yeah.
Just like that.
Yeah, yeah, dude.
He did. Uh-huh. That's awesome.
You guys should make one with Hugo on it.
Yes.
Abracho.
El muñeco.
No. He said no.
Oh, come on, dude.
No, she said el muñeco.
Oh, no. No, baracho. And then, like, we have, like, me and Jimmy, like, in the bag.
El borracho and his friends.
Yeah. Right. There you go.
Mis amigos.
Baracho y amigos.
It's good. So we're drinking a wee heavy made by Mr. Ryan Blondell over at Brewcaipa, and it's good. It's wee heavy.
This is really
it's very nice.
Heavy,
mm-hmm.
Delicious. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, no peating or no smokiness on it, but I wanted it more malt forward drinkability, and something that I wasn't expecting the raisin note to come through, but it did, which I found awesome. So
it is delicious.
That's the sweetness I
like it. I like it a lot. What about you, Soto? What do you think of that wee heavy?
You know me, I'm for anything that's heavy. That is delicious.
Oh, yeah.
I do have a drum somewhere on here, but I'm not going to hit it.
It's all right.
Yeah. Is it a heavy drum?
So apparently Juan was watching, I think it's American Horror Story, AHS. Is that
That's what he was doing. He was doing like a, an anthology or something he was telling me about.
Oh, yeah, yeah. So they were doing that, and apparently his phone's back on, I think.
Is it? I texted him and said, are you ready? So we'll be ready for some.
Are you ready?
Wait, hold on. Then you got to do like Triple H.
No, I said, are you ready?
Yeah, but you got to spit on everybody, dude.
Yeah, you got to drink the drink and
spit
it in there.
Yeah, I don't want to do that, dude. That's a COVID infraction. You can't
do
that.
Yeah. Shout out to our good friend Triple H because he gets to go to bed every night with Stephanie McMahon, so good for him. Cheers to that.
Is that a good thing?
Well, if that's what you're into.
I mean,
better than Vince.
That's Vince McMahon's daughter. She's hot.
I would much rather.
And he basically like boned his way into becoming like the COO of WWE.
Oh, dude, he's worth like.
I would much rather go to bed with Hulk Hogan than stuff.
Well, I mean, it's similar comparison.
Yeah.
What's his daughter?
They both have good hair.
Stephanie Hogan or no?
No,
what's his
no.
Brooke. Yeah.
You know what we just did, guys?
Hard to...
We just pissed off Christopher Martin.
We got wrestling in.
And you didn't love it that much.
Eat our wrestling.
Oh,
fucking...
man, we're spilling.
At least it wasn't on the board.
No, it was not on the board. It was on my leg, so we're good.
Looks like you pissed yourself.
Brandy,
somebody humped your leg. What now?
Oh, it was Brooke Hogan.
Brooke Hogan.
It was Brooke Hogan.
right?
Yeah, he's good to go.
Yeah, he's good to go? All right. So we'll finish up this Wee Heavy from Brewcaipa, and we're going to do Babes now because Juan is ready for his phone call.
Juan.
Juan, two, three, Juanito.
Dry myself up from the Wee Heavy over here.
Hey, Juan. Wow, look at you. You made yourself a mess in your pants from my Wee Heavy.
I got
that's
so
the best compliment
it's a
ever.
Wee Heavy now.
It happens to the best of us, okay?
You can say, Ryan, that your Wee Heavy made the beer dad wet his pants.
A Wee Too Heavy.
That's what I'm saying. It's a Wee Wee Heavy.
Wee Wee.
Wee Wee.
Aw, Wee Wee.
All right, so... Brando, go ahead and grab that can of Babes. And I don't mean Soto.
Hey, I'm telling you.
Their logo looks just like Soto.
I'm definitely going to have to get copyright infringements on this.
There it is.
Do it. The can of Babes, not the tuna can of Babes.
Hello?
Is this Juan? I am calling to let you know that we're wanting to extend your car warranty.
And give you some ASMR.
Finally, I was waiting for this call.
Scam likely.
Yeah.
Hey, bitch.
What's up, Juan?
Hey, how's it going?
Welcome to the Beer Dad and Brewed podcast, buddy. I'm glad you were able to come on with us because we right now currently are cracking a can of Babe's version of Josh's recipe of Citracopia, so we're excited to try this.
Right on.
I'm very happy that you were able to brew this, and I actually won't forget because you contacted me right away, and you're like, listen, before all the breweries can pick some recipes, I want the Citracopia. And so I hooked you up, and I'm very happy that you were able to make the Citracopia, and so we're going to try it.
Yeah, well, I hope you guys enjoy it, you know, tried my best. I think we try to keep it as true as possible to the recipe as well. I think the only thing that I was missing was one of the zests. I couldn't really find the heck was it? It's like that grapefruit orange thing. I can't remember what the grapefruit was. I mean the citrus was, but
Tangelo.
Yeah, tangelo. There you go. Sorry.
What is it called?
Yeah, I couldn't find any zest of that in time, so it's the only thing I was missing. But it's pretty true to the recipe.
We're trying to
get... What is going on right
know.
Now?
I don't know. We're all drunk, but
here, look, here
we're all passing a cup around
speak
trying to figure
yourself.
Out who's
speak
next.
For yourself, that's how it is.
Guy.
There you go. There you go. There
we're you go. Asking,
Dustin.
Like...
Hey, speak for yourself, right. Dustin.
There we go. All right.
Speak for yourself, Mustin.
Right?
Crustin.
Crustin.
All right, Juan. So, Citracopia. This is one of my favorite beers that Josh always would make, and I know it was one of your favorites. That's why you wanted to brew it. What did you think initially when it was done, when you tried it?
You know, I thought it drank like an IPA light, and it had been such a long time since I actually tried it. It was, you know, like 3 or 4 years ago. And from what I remember, he called it more of a pale ale.
Yeah.
So it kind of drank more like that to me as well. And, you know, I don't know. I enjoyed it. I thought it was a little bit heavy for such a low ABV beer in a sense. You know, like it drinks a little on the heavier side. But, like, yeah, I thought it was delicious, you know. I think it's, you know, nice, easy-going lawnmower IPA.
Yeah, it's got some nice body to it.
What's the ABV?
Yeah.
Thank you.
So, yeah, what is the what did the ABV come out? Do you remember?
That was a 5.9. I think the target IBU was about 55.
Okay.
And... yeah, I think the fire, it ended up, I can't remember the final gravity, to be honest, but, you know, I think that was a little bit on the higher end. It was, you know, not as dry as, like...
No, that's something that I'm noticing right now. It's definitely not dry. I don't have any stain on my tongue. It rinses clean. It's refreshing. On the nose, very citrusy. And then also you get a lot of citrus forward flavor as well. So just super refreshing. Like you said, a lawnmower beer. Crushed this during the summertime, which right now, perfect timing, right?
Mm-hmm. So, indeed.
Now I know you obviously you can some of this up for us. Is this going to be available at Babes out there in the desert on tap?
Yeah, it's on tap right now at a Babes. And I think Aqua that just opened up as well has it.
Oh, nice.
But yeah, it's on tap.
So you can go out to the desert and get it at Babes or Aqua. I recommend Babes only because the freaking barbecue food there is delicious.
Dude, I want half of this right now, dude.
You want some of that?
Seriously. I want a half barrel of this right now.
All right, he wants a half barrel of that.
He needs a half barrel of that.
All right.
Yeah, swing by, man. Let me know.
No, there you go. Definitely, dude, definitely I want a half barrel of this shit right now. Yeah. Right now.
This is good.
I'm going to walk and come get it right now.
Right now.
Jimmy would walk 500 miles.
I would walk 500 miles.
Just to drink some beer.
Wow. As you can see, Juan, we've had a couple drinks.
This is what I'm like, sober Juan. Don't let him.
Don't let him trick you. I should have stayed, huh?
You should have stayed, right.
Yeah.
He was actually here earlier. He came in and dropped those cans off, and
he
partaked in some craft lounge action while he was here. Yeah. He patronized the the craft lounge, so thank you for coming out and supporting the craft lounge.
Honestly, we'll take a half of this.
He's good.
Yeah. Very second time actually being there, man. That place is dope.
Yeah.
It's nice to reach in the fridge, grab a couple of beers to go, and drink some there, too, you know?
Yeah.
Nice.
Nice little hole in the wall here we have in Beaumont, California, thanks to our friend Jimmy.
Fucking hole in the wall.
That was a little
fucking face there, bro.
I mean that in the most respectful way.
I mean, the hole in the walls are like a block down, right?
Technically, it is a hole in the wall. Like, you have to go through a hole in the wall to get there.
If anything, it's a glory hole in the wall. Okay,
this is
a
glory hole.
When did you
disagree?
Get a...
I have never.
When did you get a glory hole at the craft lounge? I don't know.
What?
Look at your pants.
Not on the other
look
end.
Look at your pants.
Well,
look at your pants.
And there you go.
That was the wee heavy.
A
okay.
Hole in the wall.
That's our point.
Hey Jimmy, when you get this in, you're gonna have to have barbecue going on though.
Ooh.
Why are you dancing?
Pair it with some barbecue. Good idea, Sassy.
Right.
Yeah, and maybe with some brand new Muñeca's pickles.
Mmm, yes.
Oh, the pickles.
Yeah. I like it. Ryan, you like pickles, don't you?
Why'd you look at me like that?
Oh, you know.
Either you really like pickles or you don't like them. What's the deal?
Well, he gave me this look. And like,
you
I don't
like
know
pickles,
what he,
don't
I
you?
Don't know what the euphemism was that he was insinuating.
Let me try the same look
he
on
said,
Soto.
You like pickles.
Soto.
I love pickles.
Do you like pickles?
I love them.
See?
I feel uncomfortable. I need an adult. I need an adult.
Pickle beer, though.
Soto
pickle
was
beer.
Legit talking about how he could drink that pickle beer in the morning.
Yeah. Like every morning, honestly. Every
don't talk
morning.
About pickle beer in front
no,
of
No, don't.
Because
I didn't get to taste it because someone.
Jimmy drank.
But Justin drank it and shared it. My beer.
Jimmy, do you even
my defense? In my defense, I had no idea. No one told me, man.
No one told us.
We'll blame Nico just because when I left, I'm not too mad.
You could have told me, hey, dude, I left two beer for
when I left, I told Nico, this can is for Jimmy and this can over here is for Ceci.
That was your first
you
problem.
Remember,
that was your first mistake.
You gotta remember, dude. Sound moving downwards like that far.
Next
like
time you put a note on it.
It's demented, dude. Right. You can't hear it.
That's a short joke.
Justin,
Nico's a short guy.
It's 100%
Ceci,
short joke.
Don't worry. I have some at the house, so I'll make sure I get you one.
Cool.
Okay.
And if you
want
and then we can pair it with the pickle. Pickle on pickle.
Ooh, pickle on pickle.
Double pickle.
If you
that sounds like a dirty search engine.
That sounds like a sword fighting issue there.
It sounds like somebody's docking later on.
Poor Juan's like, what did I get myself into?
Oh, on the phone. Hey, what's up, Juan?
Guys, I'm still on the phone.
I'm never having
just
another
listening.
Pickle in my life, bro.
He's cracking up.
Juan needs
Juan,
some serious
like
context right now.
Hey, Juan, do you like pickles?
Oh, yeah. Shit.
You like only the fried.
You know, I'm going to plead the fifth. I don't know what's happening over there.
Lock in. Lock in the pickles, you know?
So
throw that belly
so
on the
you
back.
Walk into pick-
so let's, we'll, let's, we're gonna let's we're gonna go back to
pickles.
We're gonna go back to the beer.
We're gonna right.
We're gonna go back to the beer. So
sorry.
First
let's,
of all,
let's go back to the can art real quick.
Yeah, we have three kitties.
Will you bring up Soto again?
Yeah.
Brandon
Juan.
In the
Juan, how did you get Soto to pose for your can art?
Yeah, like I'm like the little short pig with the big old booty.
I'm working on my belly, dude.
I got like the goatee and everything. I got copyrighted
statues of that at the brewery as well.
Juan is the pig on the right, just chilling.
Oh, that's right. No, Juan's right. They have these big giant bronze statues out in
of
front
the
of their brewery.
Yeah.
We need to get Soto out there to pose next to his
brother. I'm doing it. I'm going.
We're doing it tonight.
Yeah. Hey, we'll get a spray tan. Give him a spray tan so that way.
I will bronze myself like a fucking statue.
We're gonna steal the
shit out there.
No.
As long as you guys don't siphon our silo, we're good.
Don't do that.
We're no, but I feel like can we do this? Like, can we get bronze body paint?
Yeah.
Get Soto out there with no shirt on.
Oh, of course.
Make
it. Oh,
hey, just a G-string.
By the way.
No, we'll,
I'm G-stringing. That cake. That damn pig got cake.
He said banana hammock.
Yes.
Oh, straight shoot. Banana hammock, baby.
Plantain.
Yes.
Plantain.
You got.
Juan's like, please do this after hours so I'm not working. Can we make, have to see it.
Can we make sure management is there when this happens?
I say we steal the bronze pigs and put them next to the butter churning bucket on top of the crab
cool legs. That guy
you know
look?
What I'm talking about?
Yeah, that's fucking cool.
Let's make sure we won't tell Lucky what we're doing, all right? So.
Well, there is another place that has bronze statues of pigs that went out of business, so we could go get those ones.
There you go.
Some snoring? Yes.
Nope. Those got picked up and moved.
Oh, dang it.
Dang.
Yeah, yeah. They're gone.
All right, well, Juan, we're going to go back to the beer because I want you to be able to plug your brewery because we appreciate what you did for Josh and his family during Kunkle Fest and as well as making this beer to honor him. So, Babes Barbecue and Brew House out in the desert. Tell us where it's at, how we get there, and what do you guys have to offer out there?
Oh, wow. Yeah. I'm really bad with directions, so Google's your friend.
Yeah. I get it, dude. Don't worry.
They're in the
but it's off of 111. If you've ever been out in the you know, Coachella Valley or Palm Springs area. Yeah, it's like if you're going down 111 where the strip is, if you just keep going down, you'll see it on the left is where the giant pigs are. There's also a big grain silo. Yeah, it's on, I'm Bob Hope in 111.
111 and Bob Hope, yeah.
Yeah.
It's right down the street from my hospital that I work at, so I know exactly
Yeah.
Well, there you go.
Yeah,
you can go there
see, I'm horrible with directions. Right?
Oh, it's all good, dude.
I barely
honestly
know how to get there.
If I didn't work there for the last 11 years, I would never know where anything
there
is.
You go. So. And so what's I've been there several times and I really enjoy it. But Juan, you can tell the listeners, you have food there, obviously, barbecue fare. How's the food out there?
Yeah. It's pretty good. I generally try to stay away from the barbecue a little bit, you know, don't eat that every day. Cause you know, then
you'll look
gain
like
50
babes
pounds.
Pigs. Yeah.
You'll look like Soto.
Yeah, but
we get it.
Honestly, you know, what surprised me about everything there besides the barbecue was, you know, I have the burgers every so often for lunch or whatever. And they're really good. I was surprised by pretty much all the side offerings. But it's really good food. You know, it's
my shameless barbecue plug's going to be for the mac and cheese with the brisket on top. Holy
hell. Oh, man.
Delicious.
You had me at mac and cheese.
Yes.
Yeah, right?
Heavy breathing
you
after
had me at
mac
brisket
and cheese.
Dude, honestly, I'll take some
crap. Do they have cornbread?
Oh,
yeah. Yeah, it's I don't know if they're still serving it because they've changed a lot of how they serve stuff, but they used to serve it on a cast iron skillet. I'm pretty sure they're still doing it, yeah.
Now, a question about this, and I don't know if you'll know this, because we know that your brewery/restaurant has some ties to Marie Callender's. Marie Callender's had some pretty good cornbread. Do you know if they use that same recipe or is it different?
Oh, actually, I've never asked about the cornbread, but I'm assuming because they still do the pies by hand and they have a machine that Don Callender built, I think, or something. Designed, it's kind of cool because it's still back there and they're still using stuff like that, so I'm assuming it's still there's, you know, a very similar recipe because we try to keep it true from what I hear. So
yeah, I think it's really cool as far as like kind of the story there of one of your bosses, Lucky Callender, from Babes. He is a what do you call that, an heir to the Marie Callender line, and so yeah, you're right with the pies and the desserts and the corn. I mean, everything tastes amazing, and it definitely does give you that Marie Callender's vibes. I mean, I don't know. There's a lot of people that I know that Marie Callender's was like the spot for holidays to go grab pies for dessert. I know, like, my family, we always got, like, four or five Marie Callender pies for everybody. And I miss Marie Callender's.
I miss the pot pies.
And pot pies. Oh, my
dude.
God.
Frozen yes. pot pies, yes. Even, dude. I get that.
Absolutely amazing. So that's really cool. But my family, we love to come out there and visit Babes and eat barbecue and drink the beer. You're doing a great job out there, Juan.
Right on. Amazing. Yeah, thank you. Yeah, just keeping it going, really. You know, I think the beer was pretty decent there before and just continues
keeping
to be
going.
So, I would hope. Yeah.
Now,
I'm impressed. Cool, I'm impressed with how much Juan can do in how tight of quarters that brewery is.
It is tight.
Oh, man.
It's tight.
I have
to lose weight, really. Those are some tight quarters.
Yeah, it is.
Tweet.
Toit like a tiger.
Yeah, it was. It's really cool though. What you know, a lot of brew houses kind of follow this model. But you know, if when you're in the restaurant, you know, pre-COVIDs or after COVIDs or deltas or whatever we're on now, but you have like a window there so you can actually see into the brewery. If you're in the restaurant, that's kind of cool. And one of these days, like when I'm out there, I hope to see you up there climbing around and trying to suck in your gut while you go in between the fermenters. But yeah, Ryan's right. It's tight.
Yeah, no, it's,
it's essentially a little hallway. And it, I mean, it was just designed to be a, you know, a brew pub, kind of just like an addition to be like a, you know, cool things say that they make their own beer. And, you know, you did a really good job, hired some good brewers, got some good recipes and stuff. But it was never really intended to be what it's doing right now, which is kind of a little more on the production side.
Yeah.
So it gets really tight. And then, you know, having to wheel one keg at a time, you know, to a 6 mile offsite facility is not fun. You know, but yeah, it gets tight back there.
Well, even just having a cellarman in there, like I was in there with you and I'm a bigger guy and, we were uncomfortably touching.
Uncomfortably touching.
Yeah. not through the glory hole though.
No, just front to back.
Not but, the glory hole. Well, that's awesome.
But, yeah.
You did a good job on this Citracopia, buddy.
Thanks, man.
I know Josh would appreciate it. And, you know, he would appreciate everything that's been done for him. Well, he'd probably yell at us and tell us you need to quit that. You know, he was just so humble. He didn't really like the fanfare. But he definitely well deserved because he's such an amazing person. And thank you, Juan, for volunteering to brew one of his beers. And it's available.
Yeah, yeah.
So definitely everybody, all the beers that we've had tonight, you know, go support these breweries. Go visit them. Go drink a beer in honor of Josh. But definitely if you go out to Babes, you're going to love that barbecue. Good stuff. So, it's good. So Juan, I know that you're doing a kind of a film festival this evening, so let you get back to that. But I really appreciate you letting us call and talk to you about the Citracopia because, it's a good beer.
Very delicious.
Yeah, right on. Cheers, man. Yeah. Thank you. Juan.
Cheers, dude.
All right, Juan.
You.
Cheers, buddy. We'll be in touch.
Awesome job on the beer, man.
Right on. Thank you, man. Cheers.
No problem.
Cheers. All right. Cheers.
Bye.
Yeah, that was absolutely.
It was good. Brandon, I wanted to ask you, like, so how did you like it? Because I know you actually brewed a different version of this Citracopia.
That's right. So so you gave me a version out of Josh's recipes.
So just recently? Just recently?
I brewed it for Josh's...
Kunkle Fest.
Okay. Yeah, fundraiser. And so, so that was one of the first beers on tap. Well, it was, one of the first beers among six other beers. And so I brewed that one with Lupamax Citra. I brewed it with Lupamax Amarillo and some Cascade terpenes that Josh gave me. So I double dry hopped it. I used some of the boil as well. The terpenes were added, you know, in secondary. But then I also added some, what else did I do to that?
Did you do the zest too?
Yeah, so I added orange zest. I added grapefruit zest and
is that in boil?
That was in boil. 15 minutes. Yeah. So I did a 60-minute boil, so 15 minutes. I added the orange, grapefruit and tangelo.
Yeah, one of the things that I noticed that I really liked about Juan's beer was that oil that almost rindy, oily character that you get from like when you crack open an orange or a grapefruit, like that, just that popping, that mist that comes off of that. I get that on the nose, and I think that's fantastic.
Totally. And what did you think about the beer that I brewed?
It was good. Damn good. Well, I mean, we saw at Kunkle Fest that was the first keg that blew. That was really cool, and I'm sure that kind of made you feel pretty good.
I was just happy because, to me, I felt like it was like I brewed a beer with Josh. So basically, for me, it was like if we collabed, because we collabed on this
We Heavy.
So I felt like it was the same thing. Like, it was his recipe, and I kind of threw my spin on, you know,
Fill it up.
I will.
We're gonna have.
I'm so talking about Citracopia, but yeah. So like, I got to throw my spin on that one, and I was super happy with how it turned out, and everybody was very receptive to it and really loved it. And Josh's family got to drink quite a lot of it, and I was very happy that they loved it, and that's what really meant the most to me. So it was awesome, and I think you'd be proud of it. So I was very happy with how it turned out.
It was good. I mean, yeah, both,
delicious.
Both versions.
I remember
delicious.
It.
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh yeah. Soto got the last one.
I got the last.
Yeah. You got the last one.
He was the keg killer.
Yeah. Killed it.
And the coolest thing about it though for me is that I got to add those terpenes that Josh gave me, and I was like, wow, that's fucking.
Oh, that's
awesome.
Cool. That's cool.
Because I told him, I was like, dude, I was like, I really want to add terpenes to a beer, and he's like, well, here, I got some here. So I added that to the double dry hop, and it turned out really, really awesome. So
that's awesome.
I was very proud of it.
It definitely came out good. Both versions, amazing.
Yeah.
I do remember a special time with Josh in the Citracopia. So Josh had this freaking contraption that he made.
Which one?
right. Yeah. Which one? He was like MacGyver. So he invented this thing that would infuse flavors, right?
The CO2 infuser?
Yes. So
the Randall fucker?
That's the one. So he up at Pause for Rhythm and Brews up in Idlewild.
Oh god, that was a great show.
He had that machine and he was demoing it and doing demos for Coachella Valley Homebrew Club. And I remember he had that thing, and I just remember being there and going, my god, like, what the hell is that thing? And he was like, oh, let me show you. And so he poured some, and I'm pretty sure it was Citracopia, and he's like, now taste this. Tasted it. Delicious, right? It had that citrus notes, you know, and everything. And he's like, do you like orange, you know, flavor? I'm going to kick it up a notch now. And so then he used that machine and added some more flavor to it. And, oh, my god, I was like, what the heck? He was just, man, he invented so many, like, crazy contraptions when it came to brewing. It was
his little brew, insane. His little brew setup is,
oh, that
spider.
Thing's bitching. The spider?
It was pretty cool.
He welded that thing at his mom's house in Murrieta, and for those of you that have seen it, it's just a pretty impressive, you know, for on a home brewing level, extremely impressive setup.
I like how it kind of folds into itself, which is very, very nice and compact for somebody that doesn't have a lot of space.
Right. So then he could slide it right back into his garage when he was done brewing. And what I liked about that setup is Josh was always about sharing the experience and teaching new people how to brew. And so you could literally brew several different batches all at the same time, right next to each other. And so that was really cool. And that's kind of what Josh and I did. We had that episode with Monstera Brewing where we used the salts, right? And him and I got to literally brew side by side, one Irish Red with the salts and one without it, and it was right next to each other. It was so cool. So, definitely. And his mom, Tori. Hi, Tori. I know you're listening. We love you.
Love you, Tori.
She's going to continue that tradition because she's actually asked. She wants to learn how to brew, and so I told her that I would get some of the guys to come up there into Murrieta and help teach her how to brew so she can do what her son was doing. So I think that's pretty awesome.
That is awesome.
So bring the spider back to where it started, where it was created. So
that would be kind of a fun trip. If you need a truck to take it out there, let me know.
Yeah, we're going to need a truck, and we're going to need several strong backs. So
I'm there. You, don't worry.
We're strapping it to you, buddy.
Yeah. Break out the incredibleness.
Someone strap it on to you?
No, I don't. No pegging around.
We'll paint you green for that day.
Yeah.
I can do that. I love it.
They call me Incredible Soto for
pouring over here. What are you doing?
Yeah, he is.
So I'm seeing Brandon over here. He's chewing on pizza and pouring beer at the same time, which is
multitasking.
Pretty much what Brandon does. Like when he was in Houston, always had a beer in his hand, and he also had barbecue meat in his pocket.
Wait a minute, hold on.
What?
Let's elaborate on this a little bit.
Both the fat guys really want to know how he had barbecue meat in his pocket at all times.
Well,
that's what I'm talking about.
Brandon will tell you, Houston.
Was it wrapped in? Sorry, go ahead.
Houston was an amazing experience. Something that, I know that Josh had an amazing time. Everybody in Houston, B52 Brewing, Urban South, Spindle Tap, Baba Brewhouse, we really appreciate the way you guys treated us, took us in like family, and it was an amazing trip. But Brandon will tell you we're extremely busy. We were on the go from the minute we landed until the minute we left. And Brandon likes his barbecue, and so he had to make sure that he always had some ready to go in his pocket. So he had some brisket just chilling in his pocket, so that way when
it keeps it warm.
I had about a pound or so brisket in my brisket. Pocket, accompanied by a couple Lone Star tall boys. You know,
so he was ready to go.
Too crazy.
Yeah, that wasn't brisket, though. That was in the other pocket.
Good thing you didn't have no hot links, you know. You'd have gotten confused, maybe.
you guys and your penis jokes.
Oh, that was a penis joke?
That was a penis joke.
That was a wee heavy joke.
That was a wee heavy. Talking about hot links.
Hot links.
Oh, dude, was he's talking about some smoked meats in easy to carry forms.
Yeah, Slim Jims, bro.
Bullshit, you guys are
talking about Slim Jims.
Bullshit, I know better.
So before we dive into this wee heavy that was made by Brandon and Josh, I wanted to, I just kind of thanked them there, but I want to thank them individually. I want to thank everybody that helped out with all the fundraising with Joshua for his GoFundMe, as well as Kunkle Fest. And beyond. So there's a lot of people to thank. I hope I don't forget anybody. But obviously, I'm looking at one of them. Jimmy, I want to thank you for everything that you did for
Jimmy.
I mean, I literally, like, just walked up to him, and he's like, what do we need to do? Like, I didn't even have to ask him. Yeah. So he definitely stepped up, and we were able to utilize the craft lounge to have Kunkle Fest, and that was a big deal. We raised a ton of money. After I counted between the tips, the auction, and the beer sales, we were pretty close to $6,000, yeah. So that was awesome. And so thank you. And I wanted to thank Jeremiah at King's Brewing, because not only did he donate a lot of money onto GoFundMe, but he also donated kegs as well as cases of beer to sell here for Kunkle Fest.
Plus silent auction he did.
And the silent yeah. auction. Yeah, yeah, he donated some of his personal
whiskey,
the King's whiskey, that went for high dollar too in that auction. So, you know, again, thank you to Jeremiah and Doreen there at King's Brewing. You guys have been good family members of ours and taken us in, and we wish you nothing but success at your brewery. And also, Jeremiah has a plan to make a Joshua beer every May. So look out for that next next May to honor Josh.
And
so
I do want to say that we want to do a Kunkle Fest every May.
Every May, Jimmy and I are going to get together. We're gonna do it. So look forward to another Kunkle Fest next year. Then I'm looking at another one because Ryan joined us tonight. So Ryan Blondell from Brewcaipa, again, I want to thank you so much for everything that you did between rallying all the troops out in the desert to get all the breweries to jump on board and brew some of Josh's beer, as well as brewing beer yourself and donating beer from Brewcaipa for Kunkle Fest. That was amazing. I know Josh was close to you, and so you know, definitely want to appreciate and say thank you.
Oh, you're welcome, man.
Yeah. And then everyone we talked to tonight, Devon, Desert Beer. Devon was very close with Josh, just like Jimmy. He was like, well, you know, what do you need? What do you want to do? And, you know, he did a lot. He donated beers for Kunkle Fest, for the memorial, as well as, you know, let me come and actually help brew the Uncle Kunkle Dunkel. So that really meant a lot to me. Devon's always, you know, a big proponent of Josh. He's also been a big proponent of our podcast as well. And so thank you, Devon. And Juan, how he's butchers last name, Higuera, right? How do you say it?
Don't look at me.
Ryan doesn't want to butcher it either. But Juan, the one and only. Thank you so much. Same. You've been there, and you've definitely stepped up, donated beers. We enjoyed the Brandini Brown Ale out at the Memorial. We enjoyed the beers that we had here at Kunkle Fest, and also the beer that you made, the Citracopia that we just had, is really good. So definitely head out to Babes Brewing and check that out. Gosh, I got to keep going. Coachella Valley Brewing. Thank you so much at Coachella Valley Brewing for doing something that was near and dear to my heart and brewing the Josh's Remedies or Kunkle's Remedies, because that was a beer that him and I brewed together, so that definitely made you know, something special for me. And you guys did a great job, especially to see Jimmy say that he liked it, so that really felt good.
Dude, really good. Really good.
So good job, guys. Pete and Eric, thank you guys so much. I want to shout out Las Palmas Brewing. I know that just because of busyness and stuff, we weren't able to hook up and do a recipe together, but you guys actually made a beer to honor Josh, and you had contacted me as well, so thank you out at Las Palmas. Man, got to keep going. Baba Brewhouse, you guys are awesome. Thank you so much for inviting us to your five-year anniversary and showing us so much Southern hospitality. I know Josh had an amazing time while we were out there. That was just an amazing trip. We have so many great memories and stories to tell from that trip. In fact, we've been sharing some of them, Brandon and I, tonight. But thank you for everything that you did to help raise money with the Wall Street Exchange. Also, Thomas Perry, who runs the Wall Street Exchange, thank you for doing the giveaway to help raise money for Josh's GoFundMe. I really, really appreciate it. Thank you so much. Baba Brewhouse and the Wall Street Exchange. Oh gosh, now I'm on the spot because I'm gonna start start forgetting people.
Oh dude, shout out to fucking the Beer Dad.
No, Justin, dude, you
orchestrated everything, dude. You were fucking there.
No,
you kicked ass on everything, bro. It was, none of that anything we did for Josh was orchestrated through you, and we appreciate that, bro. We appreciate
100%.
You. 100%. Yeah. 100%. Friendship for fucking Josh. Cheers to you, bro.
100%.
Thank you. 100%. Thank you. I just did it. You know, Josh was such a good friend of mine, and he would do anything for anyone. You know, like you've heard all the stories where he would give his shirt off his back to anybody. And I felt like I had to. It was like the minute I heard what happened, you know, obviously I was at SeaWorld when I found out, and I was not right. My wife knew we had to go, and we left.
Dude, when you called me that morning, dude, I was.
That was tough.
That was a rough morning.
I think that was a rough day for all of us. Man.
Yeah. I was like, I have to do something. Yeah. I've got to, because Josh was such an amazing person, and he's done so much for me in my life.
He's touched so many fucking people.
We had people that had given me stories. I met him one time, and he affected me that way. We met Craft Beer Empire in Houston, who is a vlogger, and he writes papers, and he made a calendar for women of color in craft beer. And Josh met him one time, and Josh made him cry. That's the guy that said, "Hey, I met you last night."
And, Rodney?
Because you're like, "Hey, my name is Brandon." And
he's like, "Yeah, man, I know."
And he's like, "I met you last night, dude." But yeah,
Rodney,
shout out to Rodney, Craft Beer Empire, and Women of Color and Craft Beer. Check him out. But yeah, so many people that Josh touched, and I was just, I had to do something. Just because of everything that he did for me, for my family, and for all our friends, for the podcast. You know, he was so humble when it came to the podcast. You would when you would ask him, his family and friends, they would say, "Josh, you're doing a podcast?" "Oh yeah, no, I'm just helping out a friend. That's all I'm doing." And then Andrew, his good friend from San Diego, he was like, "Oh, that's cool." And so then he goes online and he looks it up and he's like, "Wait a minute. There's like a logo, and that looks just like you in the logo. And you guys got a huge following. Like, what do you mean you're just helping out a friend?" Like, that's just how Josh was. He was super, super humble. And I just felt like I had to help out. But yeah, I did it for Josh. I did it for his family because, you know, Roxana and Tori, I know it's hard on them. And Tandy, his sister, and Rex's brother-in-law is are a close-knit family. And so, you know, just like he was close to all of us, right? He's definitely going to be missed and never forgotten, not on this show and not in my life. I'll always remember Josh. My kids will always remember Josh. He'll always be part of the show. And like we have right now, you guys can't see it because you're listening to us, but we will always have a beer poured for our good friend Josh whenever we record a show. Because... he needs a beer. Like you never saw him without a beer in his hand.
It is mysteriously going down a little bit as this podcast is going on.
It is, yeah, it is. He's taking sips slowly. So
we'll always have that picture up on the mantle of him,
right?
At all times.
So now the thank yous are starting to come back to me. So I want to thank Bearded Beaverman Brewhouse back in Branson, Missouri, Uncle Craig. He was one of the first breweries to actually brew some of Josh's recipes, and thank you for that. Uncle Craig, I was actually just with him back there and hung out at his brewery and got to taste his Uncle Kunkle Dunkel, and he did a great job on it. So thank you to him. Thank you to Don Put up at Idaho Wild Brew Pub for wanting to brew one of Josh's beers. Is that for me, bud? You could just, set over there. Thank you. Shout out to Dough Dudes Pizza again. It's for the wild.
Shout out to the Dill Dudes. What's up?
Dill Dudes. Dill Dudes.
Dill Dudes for life.
Nothing.
Oh, life. Oh, you got Chris Anderson from
yes, thank
John
you. Fearless.
Shout out to Chris
John
Anderson.
John Fearless. Chris Anderson. Talk about coming in clutch for the auction. Like, I don't know if you guys
Dude,
saw the pictures.
They went amazing.
Well, ask Brandon. He's the one that had to move it all towards
Yo,
the front.
So when I walked into the cooler, literally I was like, Jesus, Jumpin' Jack Johnson, who plagued this cooler with all this homebrew equipment? All this homebrew supplies and whatnot.
There's hops and grain.
Hops and grain and yeast. And, man, it was the whole package. Like, talk about. And it brought in. We saw, like, the whole Inland Empire Homebrew Club came out.
Well, shout out to them and the Coachella Valley Homebrew Club.
Definitely. Absolutely. They all showed up. They bid on all kinds of stuff. Alex, who was just here earlier and talked to us on the podcast, his family cleaned up on the auction because I think they won the keg, the... let's see. They won the Homebrew Mart gift card. They won, like yourself, Ryan, AirPods.
Yeah.
And something else that they won, too. And then speaking of donations, so thank you, Chris Anderson. Soto over here, my boy. He donated some golf packages to Tuckwet Canyon.
Yeah. Yep.
He's an avid golfer. You got to watch out. He's got a better golf game than Tiger Woods.
He's one of the golf pros.
Shameless plug.
He's got better
come to Morongo
legs.
Golf Club. Yeah. I'll take care of you, Alex Soto.
There you go. So he's an avid golfer, and actually we're standing right next to Hugo, who actually won that auction.
Which is nice.
Which brings me to some other people. So Muñecas Micheladas, I want to thank you guys for supporting us on the podcast and supporting Joshua. I know you guys were a big part in coming to Kunkle Fest and helping us out too. So thank you so much for pouring micheladas and donating michelada mix for that. We really appreciate it. You guys are close. You've been on the show with us. And Josh and I always think highly of you guys. And so thank you so much to you guys. Tons and Kettles Home Brewing right here. Brandon, thank you, brother, for brewing some Citracopia.
No problem.
Appreciate it.
It was an honor.
Man, I don't want to forget
Chris Martin. Chris Martin came through.
Christopher Martin. I'm sorry we talked wrestling earlier. I know you don't like
We always get distracted talking shit about Chris when it comes to...
Chris Martin,
Brett the Hitman.
Our good friend.
Brett the Hitman.
Excellence of execution.
Chris the Hitman Martin.
Chris the Hitman Martin.
Let me tell you something about Chris Martin. This guy... Number one, he donated several times on GoFundMe. Like, every time I turn around, there was a new donation from Christopher Martin. But also, he donated a lot of big bottled beers to be used in the auction. And, like, not, like, some chintzy beers you find in the market, but, like, expensive beers.
He had some Canteon in there.
There was some crazy stuff.
Like, things Europeans would, like, kill themselves. Like, they would kill each other for.
And he was having a good
People
time.
Died
but
because of that.
Also, the type of person Christopher Martin is, very similar to Josh. Kunkle Fest was his birthday.
Yeah.
And he was here, and he didn't, like, even though I said happy birthday, didn't really want to acknowledge it was a birthday because he was here to help raise money.
Yeah.
And he helped me with the auction. So, Chris, thank you so much. Chris Martin, he's been on the show before. He's actually one of the pioneers of craft beer podcasts.
Yeah.
A lot of people don't know, but he was one of the originating members of Beer Geek Radio, which was one of the first craft beer podcasts on the market. So, Chris Martin, you're the man. Thank you, sir.
And you can find him on Untapped at The Chris Martin.
You can, The Chris Martin.
You can see him battling like with Ingrid on the Craft Lounge Untapped board.
It's like back and forth.
Dude, seriously, it's like battle shit.
Yeah, it's like, we gotta watch this. Gotta watch this shit.
I posted it first.
I got you. So... you know, everybody else that donated to the silent auction, Will, I know he's somewhere around here. He's always here at the Craft Lounge.
Yeah.
He's the AirPods. That's where them came from.
Yeah, Will provided
so, was it like
AirPods.
three sets of AirPods?
Two of them. Yeah. So randomly he's like, I want to donate something. Let me go buy some. I'm like, well, like, I don't know. Like, you know how he is.
Yeah.
And so he's like, well, what do you think? I was like, I don't know, something that would do good in an auction. He's like, how about AirPods? That sounds good. People bid on that.
And he was like,
this was like randomly late at night here at the Craft Lounge. And I was like, you know, it's drunk talk, whatever. And then he shows up. All right, here's some AirPods. Have a nice day.
I'm like, legit, oh. The next day, he shows up with those AirPods. I'm like, what the fuck,
Will? That was great. Thanks, Will. Everybody else that donated to the silent auction, thank you. Thank you so much.
They're coming for you.
Yeah, more beer. More beer. What's his name?
Rob.
Rob from More Beer. Thank you so much. I contacted him, and he came right back. I was like, hey, I don't know if you heard. He's like, I heard what happened. What do you need? Yeah. And I didn't even ask him. He was just like, you know, what do you need? I'm like, okay. And so he donated those torpedo kegs and the gift card that Alex's brother ended up winning. So that was just awesome.
Here's
so,
Bob with Bottle Logic.
Yeah.
Bob, Bottle Logic, thank you. Who's the, what's the guy from?
Old Stump donated.
Old Stump donated. Thank you, Old Stump, for donating a keg. Yeah. I almost forgot our boy up at Lake Arrowhead Brewing.
Oh, my buddy Rich.
Rich.
Yeah, for Rich. Sure.
The beer trading dad or
dude,
something
that was
like
all
that.
Horace.
So yeah, beer
donated
so
and dad, Horace and Horace
so,
bottles.
So, yeah. So I got really excited when I saw those Horace bottles, and so I've known Rich for a while, and so he's a home brewer and he's like avid in the homebrew community, and so he started working at Lake Arrowhead Brewing, and so I've known him for a while, just like trading beers, whatnot, like trying different stuff. He's an awesome guy, and so he donated a keg of the very first hazy ever brewed at Lake Arrowhead Brewing, which I was super excited for because we've been talking about it for so long. And so when
damn
it finally dropped,
yeah.
I was so pumped because I went in the cooler and I saw it. I was like, oh, I want to see what Lake Arrowhead donated. I was like, oh shit. I was like, finally got a hazy. And it turned out phenomenal. And he showed up and he showed a lot of love and, yeah. You know, contributed to the silent auctions and bought some beers and hung out, watched the bands, and we were just chilling and having a good time, man. So much love to Rich
much
and
love to
Lake
Rich.
Arrowhead.
Thank you. I'm trying to remember. So we got Old Stump. Old Stump
yeah,
donated.
Old Stump and Bob from Biologic. They didn't know Josh, but after I told them about him and explained everything, they were like, 100% jump on board. We're going to donate something.
That was really cool. And there's somebody else. Ricky Whitefoot, he donated a big basket of the brewery.
All the brewery beers, dude.
So oh, thank you, Ricky. Nice. Danny Freed, she donated that big, like, outdoors like barbecue bucket that actually this is a funny story. Will, we were just talking about Will, he like had to have it. He wanted it so bad. Somebody else won it. So he paid the person that won the auction double to buy it. So not only did we already get the money from him when he won the auction, the first person, but then we got money from Will who bought and paid double what I think it was Andrew, Josh's friend, that won that. And he wanted that barbecue bucket. I don't know what it
Will
was.
Will kept messing with me. Anything that I would put a bet on, he's like,
he would outbid you?
Yeah, he's like, I'm going to put double what you want.
There you
I'm
go.
Like, all right.
Now, I did see, we talked about Jeremiah earlier. I seen him run the tables, and he started like,
Me and him were competing for a little bit. I remember that.
Oh, yeah.
I was like, all right, dude, I'm just going to like chill out for a bit. And then like, I was like, you're waiting for the last moment.
Oh, me too.
And then like, you know, we all just kind of let it go because we just wanted to see it run up.
Yeah, basically we wanted to make money for Josh.
Yeah, of course.
I will say though, at the end of the day, he did not take my Canteon.
Oh, there you go.
That's it. I did end up getting some bottles, but I shared it with everybody in the shop, and we had a good time. And
Kunkle Fest was a lot of fun. We're gonna probably start planning it obviously way earlier. This next go around, because I think we're going to try to do like a traditional beer fest in honor of Josh. And I've already talked to Jeremiah as well as Josh's mom about doing some different things. We're going to try and figure out a way to, we're working on setting up a foundation to where every year at Kunkle Fest we're going to pick somebody and we are going to raise the money to pay for them to go to brewing school.
Dope.
And
that's pretty sweet.
In Josh's really name. Cool. So that's something that we're working on. I'm just talking about it here on the show. We've been kind of talking about it behind the scenes, and I know a lot of people want to donate to that and be a part of that. So I think that's awesome because I wanted to think of something to keep Josh's legacy alive. And obviously this show, we're still going to talk about him, still reference him. He's always going to be part of our memories. But I wanted to do something to continue because that's what Josh wanted to do. He always wanted to teach new people how to brew. He was always like with our show. I mean, there were several people that we touched that we got into brewing because of the show. Like we met Alex that was here earlier, and he helped. He literally would drive all the way from the desert out to San Jacinto just to help Alex, like whenever he needed help brewing. Or the first time Alex made a stout, Josh drove all the way out there, and I went and met him, and we made a stout over there. That's the type of person Josh was. So yeah. I want that legacy to continue because I know there's a lot of people that probably want to get into brewing and probably can't afford it. And so we're going to figure out a way to pick one person per year and send them to some kind of brewing school. So I think that's a good thing.
Yeah.
That's so awesome.
Can I say one thing too?
Yeah.
I remember I was really impressed when we went to Josh's memorial. And the people from Beaumont Library were there.
Yes.
And they closed down that day. Because they're like, in Josh's memorial, we are closing down and we are here because we want to honor Josh.
Absolutely.
And I just thought that was amazing because it really spoke very highly of him. And like, you know, we've all been saying this whole show, like, he touched so many people and he wanted to help everybody out. And a lot of people in the libraries just talked about how much he helped them out. So I thought that was really awesome.
He touched so many people, and it's important to keep his legacy alive. It really is, and I'm gonna do everything within my power to get that going. Hopefully, by Kunkle Fest, we'll have enough money raised to however I decide to do the contest, whether it be an essay or I'm thinking like a homebrew, like kind of beer judging,
like a tasty,
yeah,
kind of deal.
Yeah.
We'll talk later. I've got ideas for you on that. Because I've gone to school, so there's a couple of things we can do for
good.
That.
Good.
But we can definitely get the craft beer world definitely on board with that.
Absolutely.
There's so many venues that we can go to.
Yeah.
There's so many places, so many people that would be willing to just lay it down and go all in on that.
Yeah. I mean, if you think about it, it's only helping the industry because new breweries are popping up, it seems like, every 5 minutes. And people they move on. They started a brewery and then they moved to another brewery. And there's always openings within the brewing industry. And having new brewers is really good, as well as.
Yeah, and then like how many festivals do you know that like the organizers or whatever, they just have some sort of weird kind of idea or motive behind it,
right?
Where it's like, okay, it's like a city putting it on, or this. I mean, I've helped like the city of La Quinta put on their festival, and it's like. One guy that works for it wants to turn it into a rave, and the other guy wants like classic rock, and like, they're not even thinking about the beer, which is the main focus of it.
Yeah, it
they're focusing on like the party aspect of it. But how many brewing festivals have you been to where it's centrally focused around the beer and a person?
Well, the beauty about this place is that that's what it's about.
Yeah.
So like that festival would be easy, man. It was literally everybody was here for one reason, to support one individual and the beer.
You could grow that community brand that he cared about.
I mean, Brandon, when I got here, your beer was already gone. And I was here like about an hour late.
Right.
And I was like, holy crap, it's already gone. And I thought that was amazing.
Obviously, I got here. Another thank you. Jose Orozco.
Yes.
Ooh,
hell
I love
yeah.
you. him and I were here early setting up the second set of tents and tables. Jose was one of Josh's best friends, who actually is the reason why I met Josh, because him and I were partners on the Amblamps.
Jose was mopping the floor.
He was all over the place, man. He's my brother from another mother. And
he made fun of the way I swept.
He did. You didn't do it right.
I didn't.
No.
I did a terrible job. I'm sorry, Jose.
He'll show it. As he would say, let me check it out, the baby. And he'll take care of it. But, Jose, thank you, brother. I love you. I know you're going to be listening to this on probably one of your many commutes. He is a flight paramedic now for Mercier, and he has a long commute to Hesperia area every morning when he commutes. So he always listens to our show, and he's been a part of the show many times. But thank you to Jose as well for everything that he did to help me out during this time, because it was hard. And he was there with me the first day him and I got together. We came here to the Craft Lounge, had to make that video that I really didn't want to make. And we actually drove out to the site where Josh crashed his car, and he was there for me. So shout out to Jose and everything.
Can you guys hear me? Can you guys hear me? Can you guys hear me?
We're pouring another beer. The beers are still pouring. God, I think I'm, I
I think I got everybody.
I'm trying to think.
There was a lot. I mean, there was
so,
a lot.
Let me see.
I hate it if I forget. I have been drinking, and I apologize.
So Beaumont Library.
Libraries.
Was it Cat City?
Cat City Library.
Yeah, they spoke as well.
Well, I mean, obviously Josh's family, Tori.
Right.
Thank you for being so strong, yeah. Tori, because you actually really helped me when I was having a tough time with everything to see your presence and how you were handling everything. You definitely helped me the first time I saw you after what happened, and you gave me a big old Joshua Kunkle style hug. Man, that was just, it was awesome. So thank you Tori.
100%, dude. Tori is amazing.
She's such an awesome human being, and I can't even imagine what it would be like to lose your child, being a parent. And she's just done so good and been so strong for her family. Her daughter Tandy, she put in a lot of work for Josh's memorial. It was a beautiful memorial, and you guys attended, and you know, she did a great job. Rex, her husband, he helped a lot. I want a shout out to Reclaw Brewing for coming in clutch
totally
during the memorial when we didn't have the right equipment for the kegerator.
No.
Yeah.
You guys, we got there. Brandon was trying to fix shit.
I think I did.
You did. You pretty did. You did darn pretty well. Damn good.
By the way, I didn't ask you. Did it fare all the way through the night?
Yeah. No, everything worked. It did? Yeah, everything. Everything worked. Everything we did between your MacGyvernish and Reclaw Brewing
thank you,
providing some CO2 and some tools and stuff that we needed, out of nowhere in clutch, just randomly. And I know you had never met Josh or myself in person. We just follow each other on Instagram, and that's what the home brewing community is like. You'd be surprised how willing to help each other out they are. So that was really awesome. And thank you to Garth over at it's on.
Is it on?
Yeah.
It's on?
Yeah.
I said hello,
oh,
and nobody heard me.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I just want to say really quick, sorry
yes,
for
go
interrupting,
ahead,
but
go ahead.
I just want to say the whole Kunkle Fest is an amazing idea, because just as we want to support him, we know that in anything he supported anyone. Yeah. You had an idea and he supported it all the way. And he made you feel like you were the best at what you did. So
absolutely.
I feel like honoring him and doing the Kunkle Fest every year is something amazing that we should continue.
Of course.
Yeah, we'll have to, what Jimmy and I were kind of thinking about and talking about before is doing more a traditional beer fest, and we'll have booths and stuff to represent the breweries, and we'll have a Muñeca's booth, and
for sure.
I'm sure you guys will be involved at Brewcaipa.
I'll get the forces out for you.
There you go. Yeah. We'll all be here.
Get Soto and Bronze.
Yeah.
Bronzed up, baby.
Soto and Bronze.
Looking like a babe.
He's gonna be at the Babes booth.
I'll be at Babes booth just posing all day.
If you want to take a picture, go ahead.
What if we got the three of us?
We could pull it off.
Oh, yes.
Babe. Oh,
Jimmy, get your ones ready, buddy.
Yes.
Hey, that's fucking 20s, baby. Hey. That's 20s.
Hey, you guys got to fill. You guys got to fill your own. You guys got to fill your own shorts. I fill my own shorts. No stuffing. With my belly, you won't see my shorts. I'm kind of in the same boat, so we're good then. I was like, you gotta get a car jack sometimes.
Boost it up a little bit.
I'm gonna tell you right now, the best part though is with the lady, I just throw it on their back.
Oh, he's talking about
on the back.
Oh, Jesus.
And then the suction just holds it, and you're just locked in from there.
You're
golden from there, dude.
Suction.
Yo.
Okay, must be 18 to listen to this podcast.
Yeah. I'm sorry.
18 20, and over.
21 and over.
Yeah, 21 and over.
I call that locked in.
I know,
locked
Josh and loaded. I know locked Josh would appreciate that, though.
Locked, loaded, and bloated, baby.
Podcast, and you know, sometimes it gets a little wild.
You know, the funny thing about Joshua is he's is obviously being the, you know, he was a librarian and whatnot.
Librarian.
And librarian. But he was always, you know, very straight-laced at the beginning, right? And
there are some wild
we could always call on him to, we could always call on him to...
eat butt cheeks.
Answer our questions about anything technical when it came to brewing.
Yes.
Anything librarian related, we could ask him, like, what does this mean? And he'd, like, give us this long dissertation.
Yeah.
But if you came, like, you know, three quarters of the way into the show, eventually Josh would
We'd
say some shit.
About some stuff.
That, like, butt cheek sandwiches.
Alligator clams.
Yeah.
Don't forget the gator clams.
The alligator clams.
Dude, don't forget the floating nipples.
I will never forget.
Floating nipples.
I will never forget, though. It stopped. He literally said, alligator clams. Fucking hurts.
Yeah.
Yeah, dude. Like, wait, what?
I was like, wait.
It got quiet, and he just said it, and I was like, whoa.
We hear crickets.
But he was like.
I instantaneously pictured Josh in alligator clamps, and I was like, whoa.
Where were these alligator clamps?
It depends on where his nipples were, because they floated. Apparently, his nipples floated.
His nipples moved in the picture.
He told us.
He told
a lot of San Francisco stories.
How many
and so
are we on
once he started talking about San Francisco, we knew like it was going to go in a different direction, and I was like, all right, cool. And we would just enjoy it. It was fun.
Oh, man.
Something just touched my nipple.
It was Josh.
It was Josh.
Something
with he had a nipple fetish
with a very small alligator.
Yeah,
Josh, brother, I miss you.
Miss you too,
so goddamn much.
Did you just touch my nipple?
Brother, nobody I know you're here. Mind. You're probably laughing your ass off.
You're probably shaking your head too.
You're probably like, mad at me for getting a little teary eyed there a little bit ago.
Yeah, a little floating nipples.
I hit it well, but yeah, we miss you a lot.
You are missed.
We do. Yeah, we miss.
Thank you
Kunkle.
For everything you did. Thank you for inspiring so many people.
True.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Thank you for everything. Man.
Thank you for being beautiful.
Yep.
He's beautiful.
Yeah.
Josh is beautiful.
Yeah.
Being Kunkle a sweet,
beautiful
soul.
Dude, he had these fucking cutest little nipples, too.
Just being a sweet individual. Being
How would you know where to get them?
Being a nice person.
They float.
So
they do. But so he was wearing a onesie one time, right? And it would like pass by, dude.
I will never forget
like a
that night.
I will
never
like a
forget
dude.
That
it would,
night,
like,
man.
It would have float by, like winking at you, like, "Hey, what's up, bro?" Yeah. And like fucking nipple would go by.
Jimmy could not stop staring at it the whole
dude,
night.
I'm like, dude, why are you in a fucking onesie?
The best part though. Yo, this is my favorite part though.
Onesie, bro.
Yo,
was it a onesie or a romper?
It was a onesie, and it was way too small, by the way. Way too small. And this is the best part. Yo, me and... So, Josh and Justin came with onesies, and I was wearing a pug onesie.
Nay.
And so, we were wearing these, and we thought Jimmy got the memo, but he didn't get the memo.
I didn't get the memo.
Jimmy had no jammies on.
So, no jammies.
So, Jimmy was too cool.
And even if I did?
Too cool.
Yeah, dude, yeah.
Too cool
Could you make the first ever Kunkle Fest
thing,
a pajama crawl?
That would be amazing. Yes.
Wait.
Definitely.
Hold on,
you're gonna wear pajamas.
I will wear pajamas.
Yes.
What if you sleep naked?
21 and older.
Yes.
Whoa, shoot.
Oh, I sleep naked though.
No. What about Hugo? You wearing jammies?
Well, if you sleep naked, if Soto Absolutely. Sleeps naked, then yeah. it's gonna be very reminiscent of Family Guy. Have you ever seen Peter Griffin?
Oh yeah.
The Mexican Peter Griffin walking around.
but I'll never forget. But I'll never forget when Justin he like did a cartoon. Of Josh.
Oh, Josh on the fireplace?
And we looked at it, and we're like, why is his nipple like up to his clavicle? It's like floating up to his collarbone. Like, why?
And then if you blinked, it moved. It would be like by his belly button, dude. I'm like, what the fuck?
You can do magic.
Yes.
Like, literally, the nip,
absolutely.
The nip was doing tricks. It was crazy.
It was. It would wink.
It was a magical nipple.
His nips would wink?
The
nipple was doing tricks.
Dude, he had a onesie on for like a fucking like 24 month old. Like,
it was
like,
wild,
yeah,
man.
It was like
you guys were posing in front of the fire.
Yeah,
I was like
dude,
pretending
like...
to be your dog. It was weird, but it was fun.
And
it was
I,
a good
did
time.
Did you have a leash on?
No, not during the pictures.
We should have. We should have.
After the pictures, yes. 100%,
yeah.
Yes.
After the camera stopped rolling, we did some things. You know what I'm saying?
Oh man,
Bruno Mars song was gonna come on.
I think I made mention.
No,
now,
not yet.
Dude, I can't
not
even
yet.
Take you serious right now. I mean, did I say something like, "Dude, I can't take you serious right now because your nipples are showing"?
We will. We will get to a song.
And he only had the top
button
down.
I think we need to sing at the end. But for right now, I think we need another beer poured, and I see it right there. So let's pour a beer because I want to do a toast. I want to do Josh's toast.
Us a bunch of monkish and shit.
Yeah. Monkish? Yeah. Josh would be very happy with that.
For sure. Yeah.
As long as it's not the Dodger monkish.
No, you're not going to have that.
No, this is...
Do they make an Angel's monkish?
It's for winners only.
I can drink it still, though.
They're actually opening a...
I don't discriminate. Yeah. I want to.
Oh, good. Then we can get some Angel's monkish. That'd be great.
Maybe. Don't get some Shohei monkey.
How about we don't
Trouty?
Care. Just drink beer.
Trouty, no doubties. Hey, I'm not a hater on good players. Those are some good players. Not a hater.
The Angels, the Dodgers, the Padres don't pay my bills, so I don't give a shit.
But beer is good.
But beer is always good.
Beer is good.
Unless... It
and people are crazy.
I don't know.
I'm just
kidding. That was a country reference just for you, Jimmy.
Speaking of country, Jimmy, what
was the reference?
You can't make a country reference.
Beer is good, and I said people are crazy.
Oh yeah.
So Jimmy, Brandon, and I were talking about the other day. Everything's getting back up and going. We're gonna probably do some fundraising for the show for our next trip, and we want to go to Nashville, and we want you to go because we want to take you to Music Row.
Yes.
And
you
really
want to do that?
Yes, because we want to see.
Okay, if he doesn't want to go, I'll go.
There you go. I'll go. But you need to understand what the repercussions may be.
Okay. I just want to see you in the element with Jimmy.
You're gonna come back loving country music.
Yeah, you probably may not come back because I'm in jail.
Hill toad.
I might be in jail because I'm like, fuck this, fuck that, and fuck everybody playing country.
You don't say that with a 6'9" country boy standing behind you going,
country boy.
Hey, there'd be a fucking tough fucking country boy standing behind you.
Yeah, hey, what's that guy? What's that guy's name that sings the
country boy? Because
country boy
all day, every day, twice on Sunday.
What's that guy that sings Honky Tonk Badonkadonk? He's like 6'9".
Honky Tonk.
Trace Atkins?
Yeah. Badonkadonk.
That guy could be behind Jimmy. 6'9".
Good luck with that, Trace Atkins. 280. Fuck that guy, too. First of all, his name is Trace. What the fuck is that? Is that a real name?
Where am I at?
Or is that what he does like when he does like cartoons and shit?
No, no, this one.
Is that how he does his letters?
By the way,
Trace letters?
I just want to put this out there.
Pour some out so everyone can have some.
No, yeah, I was going to say, Ryan, try some of this one.
So whoever doesn't like country music, listen to the song by Bo Burnham called Pint.
Yes.
I feel you on that.
All right. Check-in luggage from Monkish Brewing.
In Torrance, California.
And soon
to be Anaheim, California, by the way, for those who don't know.
All right, so this is Josh's...
Cheers to Monkish.
Josh's toast that he always would say. So raise him up. So I have to look it up because he had it memorized and I don't. But here's to cheating, stealing, fighting, and drinking. If you cheat, may you cheat death. If you steal, may you steal a woman's heart. If you fight, may you fight for your brother. And if you drink, may you drink with me. To Josh.
To Josh. Cheers.
That's a damn good cheers right there.
That's a good one, Josh. I love that.
Man, good beer.
Damn good beer.
Good beer.
Well, shit.
I like it. We did good, guys.
Soda.
We did good. If I missed any of my thank yous around the world with all the drinking, I apologize. Thank you to everybody that helped out with Josh. I know I didn't really mention Roxana earlier, so I'm going to mention her now. Roxana, thank you. I know this has been very hard for you, and I just hope that, you know that you have a lot of new family members that are always there for you if you ever need anything. You love don't hesitate to ask.
Love all day to Roxana.
Yeah.
So,
coming to the craft lounge, Roxana.
Come on and have a beer, have a pint. But thank you to everybody that participated in Kunkle Fest and brewing beers. I think I forgot La Quinta. I know La Quinta was making a beer too.
La Quinta, we're in transition for their new establishment, and time got away from them. They are in plans to be brewing a pilot system batch here in the next little bit. I'm not sure which recipe do they get. Do you remember? But Carlos is one of the assistant brewers.
Yeah, Carlos got it. I want to say it was God, man, was it
their new facility is stellar, by the way.
I can't remember. It was something with oranges, if I remember correctly. But
was it a honey?
There it is, the Hopa, honey orange pale ale. There you go. Yeah.
That I hope to God Scott Stokes isn't listening to this podcast, because I secretly picked that for them because one of my favorite beers they did was a Old Town Honey Wheat, and I missed that beer. And I was like, oh, you guys should brew a honey beer again. And I was like, ah, here we go.
Yeah. All right. Well, Josh loved to get together and have beer shares like we just did, and we shared some pretty damn good beers. We had two different types of wee heavies, two of them.
They were both really good.
We didn't talk about his wee heavies.
I need to go to the base of Ucaiba Mountains and get me some of those on tap over there.
Please do.
Some triple IPA from Brewcaipa. Ryan, damn fine freaking job on that.
Appreciate that.
All bronzed up.
We had some bronze paint, I'll bronze up with you. We had some Kunkle Remedies, amazing beer. Thank you, Coachella Valley, again. Devon joined us. We had some Uncle Kunkle Dunkel, which I actually got to help brew, and that was really awesome. Great beer. Head out there and grab some of that. We talked to Juan, and we had some Babes Citracopia, really good beer. Very refreshing, damn good beer.
Very good.
So thank you to all the breweries that participated and helped us out again. But Josh, he liked to have the beer shares, but Josh also liked to have fun. One thing that he would always do, and Jimmy knows, here at the Craft Lounge, is late at night, play music and sing, and just have a damn good time. That was Josh's thing. So with that being said, I think we should. Well, I don't know any of those songs.
He was all huge.
Call Me Christ. Oh, by the way. So there's a Combi Christ song that me and him were trying to figure out that we knew, and it's called it's called The Wrong Way to Kick It or something like that. But I listened to it the other day and I thought about it, and let's
pick a song that I know that he would that we can all sing along to, because I don't know any.
And in the midst of that, I'm gonna do a little guest appearance, because that's kind of a
guest appearance.
Kind of an ongoing thing in the podcast, and I know Josh appreciated it. One of the beers that Josh really liked that we snuck in there at the end was a beer from Pure Project and Bottle Logic. He absolutely loved that beer. So this is another sneak-in type beer, so it's very reminiscent of the OG times.
Pour one more. Taking some photos. He's going to pour a beer, and we're going to sing some fucking music.
Hell yeah.
Hell yeah, bitches.
What do you guys want?
Josh.
I know we're not doing country because Jimmy's here.
Hold on. This one's for Josh. And by the way,
the sound creeps.
No one does ASMR better than Josh.
No.
And the best one was, I say the best episode was the Russian River episode with the corks, dude.
Oh, yeah. He popped that cork and we about died. It almost hit me in the head.
Yo, I was going to get beer from the cooler, and I guess you guys died. Almost died when I left.
Justin had a fucking black eye. All
right.
Yeah.
Oh, shit.
All right, you guys ready?
All right, here it is. For Josh, yo. Sound creeps.
It's for you, sound creeps.
Ooh, that sounded just like our own.
Much better.
That was beautiful.
So all the way from Brooklyn. Brooklyn, New York.
Brooklyn.
What the fuck is this called? Oh yeah, Capital Unlimited. Yeah,
Capital Unlimited. Yo.
All right,
what are we singing? IPA.
What are we singing?
I don't know.
Word is born.
Word is born.
Word is born.
Word is born.
How about I don't know if this is too emotional, but the only thing that comes to my mind was Foo Fighters' Everlong.
I know, right?
So why don't we sing that?
Love that one.
It might be hard, but
Prince.
Prince.
Prince. You can do some Prince.
No, but just so you guys know.
Hey, I'll focus.
Share the love, brother. There's another one.
You mentioned how everyone was always saying in their
road
trip.
I know.
Yep.
So. Oh, this is such a good song.
Yeah, this is for Josh.
What are we playing?
Pour that beer. Raise those motherfuckers
up. Fuck yeah.
For Joshua Kunkle.
Damn right.
Fuck yes.
Does anybody need cups?
Cheers, man.
For the Liberian.
I waited here for you.
forever long. Sing it!
Tonight, I'll roll myself into.
We're so drunk.
Is there a cat hurting somewhere?
Yeah. Alex the cat. Shameless plug.
Yeah.
IG.
Alex the cat. He works at a golf course.
That was a good beer.
Calm down and waste with me. Look at, we got karaoke, guys. So you know the words.
I can't read that little screen. Oh.
Wanted it to be. I'm over my head. And I wonder when it's along with you.
It's like I'm running really fast.
Everything could ever feel this real forever.
Sing it, Hugo!
Of you, gotta promise not to stop when I say when she sang.
Kunkle.
Alright. This next line is my favorite line.
Favorite line. For you, Josh.
I'll see harmonies.
The next line?
Breathe out so I can breathe you in.
Damn.
Hold you in. And now I know you've always been out of your head.
Out of your head.
Sing it, Brandon.
And I wonder when I sing along with you.
Come on, Jimmy.
Everything can ever feel this real forever. Anything I ever feel this good again.
But you guys should hear this without the headphones on.
It's
so much been all about butt cheeks.
Gotta promise not to stop.
I was wondering how that sounded.
Butt cheeks.
She sang.
Butt cheeks. I can imagine.
Oh man, it's great. If you take the headphones off, it's like, oh wow.
That's really bad.
I feel so bad for the neighbors.
Oh man. Oh,
that
is awesome.
Gotta get that hi-hat.
That is awesome.
I don't have headphones on, so I don't know what's going on, but I know that
motion. And I wonder
why your nipple
runs. Everything could ever feel this real forever.
Come on, Soto. Get in there, Soto.
Everything could ever feel this good again.
Sing it, Ryan.
Ask of you, gotta promise not to stop when I say when.
I have really bad eyes.
All right, let's get real big fish.
Really bad.
Let's get real big fish.
Wait, more music? Oh fuck it.
Let's get real big fish.
Let's do Deftones.
Oh, White Pony.
Yes.
Let's get some real big fish.
Deftones.
Changes.
Yeah, put on Change. I'll sing that shit right now. I will sing Change by myself right now.
There was a request for
I've watched
beer.
You change.
That's the song.
Change by Deftones
into fly.
All right, here we go.
This reminds me of Josh. Cheers.
Cheers.
Oh, I don't have any more. This reminds me of Tony Hawk. We should bust out the Dodger monkish.
She called me late last night. Say she loved me more.
Come on, sing it.
Didn't matter anymore.
Come on, Brandon.
Come on.
I say she never cared. And that she never will. Do it all again. I guess I'll have to wait until then.
Here we go.
Back in trouble. Pass on the floor now, baby. You won't bother me no more. If you're drinking well, you know that you're my friend. And I'll say, I think I'll have myself a beer.
Hey, hey, hey.
Late last night, say she loved me so. But I guess she changed her mind. Well, I should have known it wouldn't be alright. But I can't live without her, so I won't even try.
On the floor now, baby, you won't bother me no more.
I think I'll have myself a beer.
I was not. I was
jamming. You were jamming.
With that being said, we have to end the show just like we always do with our good friend, the grandma.
They also practice by drinking the urine of a ram.
The what?
They drink ram's piss.
Because of the pH balance?
No, because if you can drink ram's piss, fuck, you can drink almost anything.
She said fuck.
What is the malted liquor? What gets you drunk or quicker? What comes in bottles or in cans?
Beer!
Can't get enough of it.
Beer!
How we really love it.
Beer!
Makes me think I'm a man.
Beer!
I could kiss and hug it.
Beer!
But I'd rather chug it.
Beer!
Cut my belly out to here.
Beer!
I could not refuse
beer!
It. I could really use a beer.
Beer, beer.
Beer, 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 beer.
I can't remember how much I have had. I drank a 12-pack with my dad.
Come on, Adonis.
Cheers.
Cheers, mate.